Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. It's DreamHack here in Stockholm, Sweden, and we are about to get into the semifinals of the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Tournament. We are here at the desk, and joining me, of course, are going to be Anders and Thorin. What's up, guys?
All right. How's it going, boys?
Doing well.
Yeah, doing well. This is an exciting day. We've already gone through the group stage yesterday, Anders, and it was a brilliant thing. Lots of upsets, lots of exciting matches.
No doubt about that. I think if there was no betting yesterday, but if there was, I think I would have been wrong a lot.
There was no betting yesterday. I think that was a good thing. A lot of people, you know, the streams, Oblivion, all of that. Thorin, did you get a chance to watch any of the matches yesterday?
I watched a few of the VODs. I was surprised to see NiP get destroyed as heavily as they were in that game there, especially on a map like that. You know, usually you expect that to be a map with a lot of parity. Both teams get a lot of rounds. Instead, NiP completely shocked. And then obviously, 3D Max is like the story of the tournament, really. This team wasn't even supposed, they're the Clerks team, okay? They weren't even supposed to be here today. And then here they are. They got through the group stage, they beat Dignitas, and now they get to play on the stage.
That's the big thing already. We had two French teams go through in Group A. NiP are not here on the main stage, here in Stockholm, here at DreamHack. This is their tournament, their turf, and they're not here to represent.
Yeah, that's a really big upset. There's no doubt about it. Especially because, as you said, home turf, and even more so because NIP were actually playing at Inferno Online, where they have their own playing room, and you know, they had their own lookers on the chairs. It was pretty much expected they were going to make their way through. Even if they lost to one of the French teams, I feel like that was what was on the menu, essentially. No. I think, still, I'm more surprised by the fact that 3D Max made it through both Copenhagen Wolves and Dignitas. To me, that's still a bigger upset.
It was the day of Dane killers, essentially. Yesterday, not a single Danish team made it through. Both French teams made it through. That was the really interesting thing here, because we had two of the Swedes, but Fnatic have made it through in Group B. They took first seed in decisive fashion there. No really surprise. They do look like the team to beat coming into this. They're going to be in our second semifinal match of the day. But to start us off here today, let's go ahead and take a look at the teams. It's going to be 3D Max versus LDLC. So the French team, who took first seed in Group A, destroying NiP in the process, up against the second seed of Group B, 3D Max, who had so many upsets.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it's down to. But I think the challenge today for 3D Max is a really different one. I mean, Thorin, they're playing a best of three today, as opposed to a best of one. So, you know, we were just looking at the odds on the various betting sites. What do you think? Right now it's like 90 to 10%, basically. Do you think that's reasonable?
Yeah, I think that's about reasonable. I mean, that's one of those scenarios where you have to give them some percentage because something they could play amazingly, but actually you feel almost certain like LDLC has to win this. Like the caliber of players they have, the experience they have, and also it took everything from the 3D Max guys to get out of the group. It's not like they were super convincing and we didn't know they were secretly one of the best teams. They took everything and Dignitas were still a good team, so I think the odds have to be heavily weighed in the favor of LDLC here.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at the brackets real quick and bring those up so you guys can see what we have in store for us today. It's going to be two semifinal matches, the first one about to start now, and here we have them. So our second semifinal match is going to be Fnatic, the first seed in Group B, having taken out both Danish teams in the process, as well as 3D Max. So a great performance there. And Titan, second seed, our second French team here from Group A. They managed to just barely survive versus NiP, and it was a 1v2 clutch from Kenny to do it as well. So, I mean, we're going to be looking a lot at Kenny, but that's not going to be happening until later on in the afternoon. So this is what we have for us in store today. Tonight, of course, we're going to have the grand finals here at the main on the main stage. But LDLC, 3D Max are going to be our two teams to start us off, and it does seem like they are in position. They are ready to get into this match. So we should be actually pretty prepared to get through. Actually, we do have the map bands as well, the vetoes, and you guys have noted them down as well. So we have like two papers right here, and well,
we've tried to make it look a little bit better.
This is coherent. This is definitely coherent. Yeah. So guys, just to clear things up, this is going to be the major map pool that was taken from Gamescom. So we have Cobble, the new two maps from Valve, Cobble and Overpass, that are in, as well as Cache, and Train is out. So it's a seven map pool that we'll be going into. But already it looks like the three maps that we have selected here are going to be Cache first map, Dust 2 second, and Mirage if necessary.
Yeah. So, pretty reasonable maps, I think, for LDLC. And actually, not that bad maps either for 3D Max, just going into it. I think a tough map for them would have been a map like Nuke. That would have been a lot more difficult. But yeah, Cache, Dust 2, not bad maps to start off with. What do you think, Thorin?
I think, actually, I'm surprised that LDLC let Dust 2 through. That actually suggests to me that they're not actually that worried about the Finns, because Dust 2 was the map, obviously, that 3D Max was able to beat Dignitas on. So you've just seen them beat a very good team on that map. that's one of those scenarios where when it's an underdog, you just think to yourself, right, just take that map away then. We'll just, let's make them play another map that we haven't seen them play on. But actually, that suggests to me LDLC is very confident in their game on Dust too. So Cache is the one where I'm really interested to see what will the Finns have on that map, because that's a map where the swings can be huge when you're playing teams that are very good on Cache. They utterly destroy you. Yeah. You know, it's not going to be close.
Well, is there such a thing as too much confidence going into this then from LDLC? Could they just generally be underestimating the Finns? I mean, they had a chance to see them yesterday, so they must have some, they must have had a bit of a chance to look at them.
I think there's a degree where you can have too much confidence in that sense, but then again, maybe they just have something in their own Dust 2 game where they're more confident in that. It's like they don't want to take away what they think this is going to work for us. That's another thing. Okay, sometimes you see this in tournaments where a team wins a lot on a map. So a famous example, VODS Pro won all those games on Mirage, but NiP still let it get through in the final at EMS against them. But the reasoning was, when NiP were watching them play Mirage, they were like, oh, I think I still see something that we could do that would work okay. Turned out to be wrong in that case, but sometimes you might go against what's like the conventional wisdom because you think to yourself, no, our strats would work though, even if it didn't work for other teams. So I think LDLC just think to themselves, like, they won't do what they did to Dignitas against us.
No, that's going to be something as well. But the big point I think that you're making here is also is that they have information on Dust 2, and they've obviously been able to go over it, review data last night after the matches, after the groups wrapped up, and they actually know what to expect from 3D Max on this map. Now they would have seen everything pulled out of the sack to be able to beat Dignitas from 3D Max. So do you want to face them on a map that you have no information on, or do you want something that you have a little bit of a head start on and you're going to be able to kind of expect what's coming at you?
And a sort of a secondary point as well, because LDLC is also a new lineup. It's maybe easier for them in general to play Dust 2 than it would be for them to try and put themselves on Nuke, or even maybe even worse, some of the new maps like Cobblestone and Overpass, which have been conveniently banned out.
Yeah. We didn't see those on day one. Didn't see Overpass. Didn't see Cobble.
It was actually the day of Cache yesterday. Group B in particular was like three.
No, it was a repeat of what happened at G3. Similar. Cache rules everything around me.
cash money.
Wu-Tang.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's the thing right now. There's going to be a lot of information from both of these teams for Cache. So they can figure, they've already seen some of the teams play them out. 3D Max have already played on this map. So again, this is information that LDLC can put to good use here going into the semifinal. Best of three, if you've got an idea what your opponent is already going to be doing, that's a lot of information to be able to play off of. The big thing here is this is going to be Mirage. We haven't seen Mirage at all, in fact. So Mirage to start things off, or at least as map three to settle things.
Well, could be interesting. I think the French teams generally have been doing pretty well on Mirage. I don't know about this exact LDLC lineup, but I would be surprised if they don't have a pretty good understanding of it, even just playing the basics.
Well, I mean, we saw them play yesterday. It was Titan and played LDLC on
LDLC,
Mirage.
Of course,
and
right.
LDLC won a fairly close game. And famously, obviously, Titan, at the end of their lineup, their previous one, were quite strong on Mirage, actually. They used to be one of their home maps at G3. We saw them pick it all the time in the group stage. So you take the different parts and you put them in different teams. I think the sum core of it still remains that they're strong on these maps. I think this will be the strongest map for LDLC, actually, Mirage. I think it's the one I expect them to be very powerful on.
I mean, someone was asking me on Reddit yesterday, who's going to be winning between these two teams.
Okay. I didn't answer them because it's just a Reddit user. I understand. Nice story. What happens next?
Well, essentially, what it comes down to is if I try and match up, like, just on a one-for-one basis, you take any one player from 3D Max and you put them up against any one player from LDLC, say they probably come out on top. But I would have said the same with Dignitas.
You mean the LDLC players come out on top there?
Yeah, the LDLC.
Okay, you made it sound like it's
No.
Okay.
Yeah, I meant the LDLC players. And I would have said the
skill
same.
Skill-wise, man for man, they outmatched.
Yeah, and I would have said the same with Dignitas. So that actually is the one reason why, the 10% that we were talking about is I would also reserve that just saying, because I made the same analysis with Dignitas and turned out to be wrong.
Yeah.
I guess there is room for something. But I think, again, the upset is much more difficult to get when you're in a best of three.
Yeah, especially because the thing is, in a best of three, really good teams who are tenured and they've got the experience, even if you shock them on that first map, think of the last two times the Complexity and Cloud9 guys played against NiP. They always won the first map. They came out guns blazing. Everything was going amazing. Map two would always be like they'd be sort of leading. They'd be in position. And then all it took was once NiP had enough time, they would gradually adapt, and then they would just be winning the rest of the game. And so that's the problem if you're the underdog team. If you're the underdog, I usually say you have to just smash it 2-0. You have to just play out of your mind the first two, because if it gets to a third map, that's when the experience always shines through.
No, that's exactly the case, and that's exactly what we can see here. There's still a lot of experience on 3D Max, but because they have had time to play together as a lineup, their last LAN final was actually Aces ROG just a few months ago, and they took second place there behind My Revenge. So they do have the experience together, and they do have experience on the stage. Now, is it going to be enough here to be able to take on one of the French giants on the main stage here at Stockholm? But we should be able to get up there and have a word with them very soon here. We're going to actually have a chance to hear from both of these teams, not to an NBK. We're going to get to hear from one player from each team and have a short interview with them just to get their thoughts on what is going to happen going into this match. And of course, you guys are going to get to see their lineups as well. But that's not going to be for another moment here. The big thing, I guess, is that basically we have LDLC, so much talent, sheer talent on this team, because we haven't really even been able to talk too much about it. But now it's like perfect playing conditions for Shoxi. It's NBK, mountains of experience with Smiths coming over from Titan. Happy is there to give his experience as well. And then you just have the Mad Fragger Kiyoshima, who played out of his mind yesterday and did a lot of work for LDLC. I mean, this team is certainly the favorite to get into the finals and really put up a strong challenge versus whoever comes from the other side of the bracket.
I mean, one sentence that stuck in my mind when I was talking to Shoxi at, oh, it was either Cologne or Gfinity. I can't remember, but one of the two events, and he said, what I feel like sometimes playing with you know, the then Epsilon team is when I'm dead and I'm watching them play, I wish I could sometimes sit down and take over, like pause the game in a certain position, and then...
So he wants a bot, basically. He wants someone to leave the game in a tournament match, and he, now I get to play again.
Yeah. Spam T,
because,
take it over.
Because,
exactly. Well, a little bit, you know, but just in a sense, I can understand what he says, you know, I don't have time to explain, or I can't explain properly how I'd want them to play this position, but I feel like I know, and I think with his current team, there's much less of that. I think he's more, he has a lot more trust in the individual skill of his teammates, essentially. Not necessarily to kill people, but to make the right decision in the right moment.
Well, the thing is, okay, people always think if there's like a really big favorite, like obviously LDLC is a huge favorite to win this best of three, they might think that makes the game boring. Okay, what's the storyline there? You hope it's a big upset. Actually, there's an interesting storyline just in look at the LDLC side only. If LDLC is going to make it to the final, as we would expect, then this is like, okay, if they're going to play a team that's in theory inferior, well, then we want to see a very impressive performance from LDLC. If LDLC is going to challenge whoever makes it from the other side, this is where we're going to see how battle-tested they are. If they stumble a bit here, if they lose a map to 3D Max, then that puts their own chances in jeopardy, even if they make it through. So to me, this is more like a workout. Let's see what LDLC is actually capable of.
And I think all eyes are going to be turned to 3D Max as well. I mean, we are here in Scandinavia, Finland, huge CS fan base there, and they're going to be looking to 3D Max to actually have a strong performance here, and we'll see if they can actually change up anything, because you can be sure that, as we said, LDLC have had time to study these guys. Now are 3D Max, obviously knowing that they've been studied, are they going to be able to change up their game enough to be able to potentially catch LDLC off guard in those key rounds?
I mean, Thorin, maybe you can help us out with this. What's sort of the history of Finnish, you know, Counter-Strike? Because as far as I can tell, there's actually been a lot of hype in the Finnish scene, also outside of some of the recent you know, comebacks, like Aslak being one of them, Reed being one of the other guys. Yeah. So do you think this could help the Finnish scene spark a bit of you know, a bit of a revival?
The main thing about the Finnish scene is it, like, except for Sweden, because that always had the established base, all the other countries in the Scandinavian region always had very high-skilled players, but they always had, at one point Denmark would have a couple of organizations, then Finland would have someone, and so the other three were always, like, juggling up second, third as to who was, like, the rankings in the Scandinavian. Sweden always first, the others were, it was debatable. And what it usually came down to is which team got, like, their genius player onto the best team. Okay, so if Denmark got, like, Sunder or Wimp onto a really amazing team, they could be the second best in the Scandinavian region. But it's true, actually. Finland had some lineups with, like, Ruit and then the latter days with Aslak where they were competitive. So actually, I think this is a key thing. If a team like 3D Max establish themselves, they get a good performance here, and they can go to other lands, then that's what could lure one of those guys out. Like, okay, stop just playing for fun and on the side. Like, actually, maybe there's a team now that can potentially go to a major and do well. That's where maybe Ruit or someone does step forward and they go, right, I'm going to be a full-time pro again. Because really, in every country, you need the genius player. Like, if you think about it, when Nico from Western Wolves stepped away from the scene a bit, it took the Danish scene a long time to get back to the level of having a real contender for a tournament. Yeah. When you have those genius-level players, you can't, like, throw away that talent. You have to figure out a way to get it into the best team somehow.
So, and I guess...
The major is the carrot on the stick, and it's like, you know, going along. Yeah. And hopefully they follow.
Even Lopez has made his way to Global Elite, so maybe there's a...
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe
it only took him 50 hours, apparently.
Yeah,
so.
Hope. He's there quick. And his brother Nasu has been playing for a while too. So I mean, it does seem like there's some movement in the Finnish scene going on.
Are you suggesting that they're going to get the boys back? The band is going to get back together again. They're going to meet in a room like, man, we used to be beautiful. Let's do this again and like crank the music.
Like when Take That make a comeback. Yeah.
And then we'll do one of those videos like that intro video for DreamHack with them all coming together. You know, meeting of the minds.
I'd be very happy. I'd be very pleased if we can get that happening.
DreamHack, we're calling you out now. Make it happen, please. Send a crew up there, but. Apparently, we have a bit of a delay with one of the players, so that's why we're waiting to get into this match, guys. So we'll be getting into it very shortly here, because, of course, the stage is right here, and you guys will get to see that in just a moment's time. But, I mean, it would be amazing to see the Finns come in. What's really interesting here, the storyline, I think, that's going to be fantastic to see develop is going to be, obviously, these two new French teams, the new mix coming in. So we talked a lot about LDLC, but there's also Titan on the other side. Both of these teams wound up in the same group, and both of them went through that same group, through one of the favorites to take first seed in that group, NiP. who were here on home turf, as I said earlier. This is pretty much their stomping grounds, and this is almost the first time, I think, like in the last 2 years that they have not made it out, A, of a group, and B, not into like the playoff finals of DreamHack.
I mean, similarly, you say they were on home ground. Usually when we say that, okay, we say about like the Poles, for example, when they're in Katowice, like they're on home ground, even if they're not from Katowice.
Oh, I've just opened this up for you, haven't
they? They were literally in the NIP room, in the NIP chairs, with probably a NIP scarf on, having a drink out of a NIP like mug or something.
And they reach over into their NIP bag to get their NIP hoodie.
So if they lose at that point, it's like, what can you blame, you know? Like, oh, the conditions were perfect. That's exactly where I practice, literally. Like
the humidity was too high.
Yeah, yeah. Although I imagine there was a lot of toxicity in that room after that loss, you know. Maybe some sort of leak, you know.
Could be.
The heat was rising. Flan's chair suddenly felt really warm. Like, usually feels quite cool when I'm playing it. It usually doesn't matter if we lose, you know.
Damn. Yes. Yes, indeed. But, I mean, yeah, the Titan lineup. How do you feel about this lineup? Because there seems to be, I mean, it's Existence leading it. Yeah. And, you know, historically speaking, he's had a fair amount of success leading teams.
I think that's an understatement. He's one of the greatest leaders of all time, for sure.
Yeah. So do you think he can do it again with this new lineup?
Possibly.
Sure.
But let's go ahead and find out. We can potentially ask him now. We're going to go ahead now. It is time to get up onto the stage and actually meet our players here. The two teams that will be competing first in the semifinal match. This is a single elimination format, so it's a best of three that's going to settle it all. But we're actually going to go ahead right over here and head over to the main stage, where we have 3D Max and LDLC waiting for a chance to fight it out. As I go ahead for a bit of a stroll. What's up, everybody? Hello. Hi. Oh, no. Of course. It has to be me. It has to be me. I can't not get up onto a stage and mess something up. So we'll give a little bit of a mic spin as well, just to really get into character. But now, let's go ahead and actually do this right. It's going to be 3D Max, the first semifinalist team, the Finnish hope here at DreamHack Stockholm. And we are going to get them up onto the stage first, hopefully. And they should be coming. 3D Max, come on! Get up onto this stage! All right, well, let's go ahead and take a minute to meet these players, these guys who have actually run it through Group B, taken out both Danish teams in the mix. But our first one that we'll be taking a look at is Karong, the man, the legend. He destroyed everybody yesterday. He had a fantastic performance, and this is going to be more of the same today, I'm sure. Now, the man to his right, or his left, our right, is going to be Natsu, one of the most experienced veteran players in Finnish CS. He's been through it all, and it's excellent to see him on the main stage again. To his right, of course, is going to be the man calling the shots, Reflex. Also, a very strong performance yesterday throughout the group phase, and we're definitely going to be looking to see more of that today. To his right, or our right again, is going to be Zard, the master offer, the man who's been doing the damage with the sniper rifle, and we shall see if he can measure up versus his opponents in this first semifinal. The last man to his left is going to be Disturbed. Oh yeah, Disturbed looks focused and he looks happy, so this is going to be good. Tanelli Veikola. But now, let's go ahead and get their opponents up onto this stage. The Frenchmen, the newly formed team, the All-Stars, LDLC! Now, LDLC, through some very recent team reshuffling, this is the new lineup that we have before us here. The former lineup finished semifinals at Gamescom. The new one, we expect much more from. We're going to go ahead and meet our first player. On the very end, it is going to be their opper. Mountains of experience. Smith, the man, calling the shots, playing the key roles, and definitely lending a hand in the calls. It's going to be Edouard Dubordeaux. Smith, to his left, the young gun on this team, the man who runs around, ultra aggressive, gets the frags. It's Kiyoshima, Fabien Fay. Now next is going to be Richard Papillon, Shaxi, leading this team now, replacing NBK very recently, but also insane, viewed as one of the best players in the world. To his left is going to be Happy as well. One of the masterminds behind this team, Vincent Servigny. He makes the plays leading into these matches, so we're definitely going to be looking to him to lead. And NBK, our last man here for LDLC, Nathan Schmidt. There we have it, Nathan Schmidt. The man who actually was the leading force behind this team. After everything shaked up, LDLC, Titan, they all got shredded. Epsilon as well. Nathan, he was the one who had the vision to put together LDLC, and they are here on the main stage today. But it's now time to hear a word from both of these teams. So we're going to bring Natu up from 3D Max, and we're going to bring NBK up from LDLC. We'll get them up here center stage, and watch the step. It's a bit high. All right. There we are. So, guys, welcome. You're here on the main stage of Globe, Stockholm. This is everything that we could have hoped for. So I'm going to start with you, Natu. You're coming here from the Finnish scene. I mean, already, just to start it off, what do you have to say to all the fans out there? I mean, there's been a lot of commotion on the social media.
Yeah, I mean, Finland has had a bit of a struggle the past few years. We've not really had a team that's been able to compete with the better teams. So, I mean, everyone's really excited. They're finally getting a team that's actually being able to compete with these guys. So, I mean, you know, keep it up. Keep up the spirit.
All right, I mean, it's really fantastic to see the Finnish team. Exactly, guys. Crowd is here, and it is gathering. It's still early here in Stockholm, so there's going to be more of a crowd for sure as this progresses. But NBK, same thing for you, actually. You took first seed in convincing fashion yesterday, crushing through NIP. But there's a lot of eyes on you now after this recent team reshuffle. What do you feel what do you make of the situation?
Well, we won the group stage. As you said, we managed to win against Titan, one of our main opponents. And then NIP, yeah, we had a very convincing game. We were actually surprised by the result of 3D Max yesterday. I mean, I think not a lot of person were expecting them to come out of the group. And they played extremely well throughout the group stage. So now it's up to both our teams now to compete as good as we can. And, you know, we're still pretty confident in the game.
Now, are you confident with how your game has developed so far since the team has come together?
Well, I mean, on the maps we practiced, we are very, very confident. I mean, we took NIP down, as you say, in a very convincing fashion. We managed to play an excellent game. Against Titan, it was more shaky, but we still managed to win some good rounds. So, regarding the best of three, I think coming into the three maps, there is no weaknesses into the maps. We are ready on all three maps.
All right, well, best of luck there. Natu. I mean, this is the thing. He's saying he's very confident versus you. How are you feeling after last night's matches, the struggles in the group phase? Are you guys feeling good and prepared going into this one?
No problem at all. I'm okay. We're confident as well. I mean, you know, we played very well as a team, and that's going to be where it's at for us. I mean, we need to have our team play going if we want to compete with teams and with these guys as well. So if we just can play up to the standards that we're capable of, I think we can take it up to them.
All right, well, best of luck, gentlemen, if you want to shake hands before we get this going. Man, this is going to be a sick match. Good luck, guys. All right. So, we couldn't ask for a better match to start things off here already. 3D Max, huge potential. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. And LDLC also still up in the air as to who's the top team in France right now. But LDLC definitely showing with a very convincing play yesterday in the group phase that they are the team to watch from France. We shall see their compatriots later on in the second semifinal. But first, I'm going to walk back over here and rejoin Anders and Thorin, who didn't stumble on the stage. You guys just get the easy job. You get to stand back here and not do anything. So what's up?
Well, on the other hand, if we had been stumbling, it would have been even worse because we would have been standing still. It would have been really weird.
That would be a little bit odd. Okay. Yeah. So what do you make of what's been said already?
Well, I think we did talk it over to some extent. And I think ultimately, I mean, it's good to know that 3D Max is going into it with some confidence. But I'm not sure. I think it's still going to be a really, really tough task for them. I don't know. I have a hard time seeing them making it, but if they could take a map, that'd be impressive. All on its own.
This is sort of where, you know, you'd like to say it's all about like the confidence of the underdog. Are they plucky? Do they believe they can do it? But sometimes, even if you believe you can climb that mountain, it's still a struggle. Like when someone tried to get up that step up there, and you still fall flat on your face. Everyone looks. You try to dust yourself off and continue on, but everyone remembers what happens. They feel a bit of that schadenfreude for you. I feel like that's what might happen to the Finns now. It might just be a 2-0 pasting. Over to you, Samba.
The important thing is whether they accept it and roll with it. And yeah. That's the thing as well, because they're already getting experience on this, and they're going to be able to come out of it stronger, I'm sure, especially after that performance in the group stage. The experience that they're going to get from some of the best players in the world here facing them on a land setting, on a main stage event like this, is a lot that they can take away going into future events. And, you know, I'll try and watch my step next time as well. So. Hopefully, we'll be able to get in here fairly quickly. Anders, what do you say?
Yeah, hopefully we will be live any second. But until then, it's actually, I mean, just thinking about this from 3D Max, from the organization's point of view, they've got to be pretty happy right now, right? You know, they kind of halfway randomly get invited to this, and they probably think it's a little bit of exposure getting here, and then their team actually does pretty well. Which I think is, you know, just to you know, any other organizations that are out there, is kind of must be interesting, realizing that, wait, there's actually a game here where we could potentially pick up a team, and then maybe they just do really well and we get, you know, a lot more than we asked for.
So, I agree.
You agree?
No,
good.
3DMax, the 3DMax team definitely blowing it up on Twitter yesterday, as you all can be sure. I mean, they've got to be super excited, especially. I mean, already managing to get to the point where they eliminate Copenhagen Wolves, that's already a very good result coming out of this for 3DMax. And then they were able to take out favorites for second seed, Team Dignitas. So.
I mean, if you just looked at their performances, look at the teams that you just saw on stage, and then think of how their performances. You know, the 3DMax guys were very workmanlike, they were very blue collar, they were down in the trenches going through it. Meanwhile, the rock stars of the scene who just come together, they kind of walked in there very suave, very stylish, the way they won the game. Don't you agree?
Yes, absolutely.
Is that it? Are we turning this into the story of the working man fighting up? I mean, this could be the revolution. And, well, these guys are going to know all about that, right? So we'll see if they're actually going to be able to overturn things here. It seems like we were just trying to get a couple things sorted out. Robin, big shout out to Robert, our admin, as well, who's making sure that everything runs here smoothly at the tournament. So we shall be off to a fine start here. But I mean, Cash, Dust 2, Mirage, again, we talked about these maps going into it, and we saw plenty of Cash yesterday, but this is actually going to be a perfect map to start things off on, I think, because there's a lot of information to go off of. There's already a lot of experience in this tournament to go off of, and so both of these teams should be feeling fairly confident going into it. The man that I'm watching here from 3DMax going into this is going to be Caron, because I'm expecting big plays from him again, because he performed out of his mind yesterday for the team throughout that group phase to put them into this position here. So I'm hoping to see that he can continue that performance and really be that key player here for 3DMax.
Yeah, Reflex, I think, showed, you know, I guess he lives up to his name. He actually has like a really, really fast aim. Ixad, I feel like he had his good moments, but I actually think he has a higher level than that we haven't seen yet. And now would be a really good time to find it. Like, he didn't play badly yesterday, not at all. But I just think from having watched him for a while play in the online games, I think he has like a deeper level than that. So it could be worse.
I mean, I actually thought Disturbed was the guy who really stood out for me. He had a very solid performance throughout all the games pretty much, and looked like he was at times ahead of his teammates, actually leading the way. So I think there's definitely players here who, regardless of the outcome, win or lose, can have like standout performances and can show their stuff, which is another thing. When you play these big games, you don't want the players to get dragged down if their team's losing or something. Big time players who are going to go on to be in the top teams, they're the guys who actually can be in position where they know, like, oh, even if I'm in a lesser team now, if I show my stuff now, one day I'll be in a better team. I'll get that offer. Maybe I'll be in the Alu to Mouse Sports next type scenario, you know. This is a perfect chance to show it now in a big semifinal.
I know that.
And you're right in bringing up the stub, just to back it up with some stats here that HLTV put up. He did end up against Dignitas with a 37 and 23 kill death ratio. So 37 kills against Dignitas, that's got to count for something.
And a very skilled team, obviously, Dignitas, and great on CT sides. Like, that's a hard team to get put up frags against. Yeah. Legendary for their CT sides, obviously.
Yeah, so just going off the scoreboard from yesterday against Dignitas, Natu lower on the scoreboard, but as we said, I mean, how long has Natu been actually playing Counter-Strike at a pro level?
Amazingly, the first time I ever met Natu was in 2001. And right back then, he was actually the youngster in the scene. At the time, he was like maybe 17, 18. I might be actually 16 at that time. And at the time, believe it or not, his game was totally different. He was like an aimer. He was like a Kiyoshima type guy, like an aim star, and that's what he came into the scene for. But in the latter part of his career, he's transitioned to what he became now. Like, he's like a glue guy type guy, where he just does his workman role within the team, but his main role within the team is actually keep the egos in check and then make sure this guy who's new on the scene knows like some of the things you have to do as a pro to make it and catch mess around here, and you have to turn up to practice and stuff. And that's why he's always around in these Finnish teams now. Even if they change the other players, he's always a core component, because there's no one else who can match that level of experience and has actually been there and seen different levels of player and used to be a different type of player himself. So maybe he can relate to the guy who's an up-and-coming player like a Disturbed or Kayan. Yeah, these are the guys who can benefit from something like that, I think.
No, he's also got, I mean, coming off of that experience as well, he also has that work ethic behind it, because this guy really never stopped playing. I mean, even if he wasn't competing in teams, he was still playing in the background, just waiting to be able to get back onto one and start getting back onto the scene. So it really is a pleasure to see Natu up here on the main stage now, especially against the young guns that he has here at his sides.
Is there any element in which 3D Max is coming to this feeling like we have very little pressure on us? We've already done really well at this event. Even if we end up being too old here, we still represented ourselves and done really well. Whereas LDLC, you know, they right now, especially having defeated NIP and Titan, they probably think, all right, we're going to go through, we're going to reach the finals, and we're going to try and win it. So that level, the different pressure, do you think that could affect, you know, positively for 3D Max and negatively for LDLC, or is that...
Whenever people say that thing of like, oh, we're not going to underestimate our opponent, like we're going to be focused 100%, you can say that, but the whole point is you can't really do it, because you don't consciously think, right, these guys are trash, I'm going to beat them. It's the idea that you sort of know, if you feel like you can't lose, that's when you just can't fully engage the same degree. If you lose a round, you think, I'm going to get pick it up next round, that doesn't matter that much. That's the sort of scenario that, yeah, LDLC could be in, because they know they have to win this. If LDLC didn't win this, even if it was an incredible game by 3D Max, to a degree, they'd be a laughingstock. People would be like, you threw away a final that should have got to. You know, you got through the group stage in first. Why, you know, it'd be all the fingers would be pointing at them. People wouldn't even be pointing that much at 3D Max. So I think for 3D Max, the only thing I worry about there is, historically in Counter-Strike, the Finnish teams in general are a bit emo. And like when they start losing or they get behind a bit, they're not really the guys who like pull each other together and like, yeah, we can do it. The guys, they're like, oh, I knew this would happen. God, that's a shame. What time's the bar open?
Where's the sauna?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's a shame, because actually I was hoping, because their level of excitement when winning was, you know, not that high.
It was a bit muted.
Yeah. So I was hoping
inside, I'm sure they were just having, they were like Bugs Bunny on the moon at that point. They were just like having, but very cool, calm exteriors, you know.
But I was hoping it would work the other way too, so that when they start losing, they'd still be like, oh, it's pretty, you know, we're just playing on, you know, that it
yeah,
works both ways.
Yeah, but then inside, they're just like being worn down by like the weight of what's happening to them, and they're just rethinking their lives. And, you know, I mean, I had a good job before I was doing this. What am I doing now? I wonder if my manager's still got that spot open.
Do you, I mean, talking a lot about 3D Max now. On the LDLC side, Shoxi,
yeah.
Where do you rate him currently on sort of the top 10 list of you know, best players
yeah,
in the world?
Yeah, he's one of the hardest to place, actually, because he still does have those games where he's absolutely nuts. Mm-hmm. But then on Epsilon, it's hard to blame him too much on Epsilon, because he wasn't playing like his best roles. He wasn't in position to be the superstar every game like he was when he was on Titan. And at the same time, Epsilon was losing a bunch of games, so it's hard to shine when you're losing all the time. So I'd still have him in like my top five. But I think at this point, that's actually one of the things I'm looking for in this new LDLC team. Will he be the star of stars in the team? Because they have a lot of skilled aimers. Or will they become more like a Fnatic or even a Dignitas or something, where it's just a collection of aimers, and there's one guy's a star one time, one guy isn't another, you know?
That's it right there, though. I think you hit it right there. It is going to be a collection. That's the focus behind this team, is everybody steps up. Everybody has so much experience, and Shoxi, that's the big point. Now, we made it earlier a little bit when we were talking about LDLC, is the fact that on Epsilon, he never really was able to count on his teammates to be able to do what he saw that needed doing. But on LDLC, himself, he's already comfortable with it. He says, okay, well, all of my teammates, they have years of experience. They know exactly what to do in any given situation. I can actually just fully focus on my game and focus on the calls that I need to make sure that they're going to be in the positions they need to be in. So Shoxi's already said, you know, it's a total night and day difference here from going, you know, with his previous lineup to this lineup now. And that's the real strength of LDLC, is four of these players have got years of experience at the top of the scene. Happy getting up there with LDLC in recent times, but also MBK and Smiths. I mean, those guys with Titan, with Barry Games, just years and years at the top. So these guys have so much experience going into it. The main thing is going to be Kyoshima and how smart and intelligent and aggressive he is. You know, he's going to be a really point man here for LDLC. I think he's the man who's going to be the one that we need to be keeping an eye on to have that big genius star performance of, okay, he's in that position, he's going to get the frags, and he's going to be the one making the difference.
So speaking about Titan, actually, because what you said is, well, yeah, in Titan, Shoxi had the ability to play his ultimate level.
Yeah, and everything was in place for him to be the star, you know.
And that actually is a feeling I've been having for a while with the old Titan lineup, is that they were sort of like a structure that where you could put like one star player on top of that structure, and that person would go nuts, because everyone else below, like the rest of the structure, knew what to do to sort of uphold him.
Yeah, yeah.
So when they removed Shoxi, they put in Kenny. And it feels like they could have probably kept doing that for a while, like trying to find different stars. I mean, people were even talking about someone like Apex. I mean, maybe that doesn't seem as relevant now. But if you put... I mean, I'm hoping that the current Titan structure has changed so that they're not just revolving around having like one guy have a superstar performance. Because I think it's hard to win a lot of tournaments like that. Maybe
the problem
one.
Is the it's one guy has to be really that good. He has to be that great. He can carry every game. We've only seen a couple of guys ever do that in CSGO consistently. You know, otherwise, that's why these teams like Digging Stars, et cetera, they overload on aimers because they don't have the one guy who every game goes for. Okay, Device is an incredible player, but I've seen him have big semifinals where he doesn't appear, you know, and someone else has to take up the slack. So that's a great structure if you have the genius player and you want to make him shine the most, but it's very difficult to do that because there's not many of those players around.
And also just having the consistency, exactly, because we do see, you know, before the team change actually came through, Titan, when they were focusing on Kenny, and he still is actually at the point for, excuse me, for Titan, but when they were focusing on him beforehand, you know, he was that point man for him. But the only question was consistency. Is he going to be able to come through in the rounds? And you would have entire halves where Kenny never really showed up, and then it swaps over, and then it all of a sudden starts looking pretty good. But that's enough of that. We're going to be getting into the game now here, and it's going to be the first map of this best of three, the first semifinal here at DreamHack Stockholm. And it's going to be between 3D Max and LDLC. The knife is to settle on which side these teams will start. If they're going to be on the offense on the T side, or if they're going to be on the defense on the counter-terrorist.
Yes, indeed. So welcome to the show, everybody, here. First map in a best of three. We're at the Ericsson Globe in Stockholm, Sweden. And on the Finnish team, they made it through after all. We're going to have to see if they can continue to do what they've been doing yesterday. And Cash may be a good map. Not sure the knife is going to make such a big difference who starts on what side, but again, 3D Max, they are the underdogs. They probably need whatever they can get. So starting on the CT side, this might be a good idea. And then winning that pistol round to follow it up.
Oh, exactly. I mean, the CT side is kind of the slightly favored side on Cash, but that's a point that Thor made earlier, is the fact that certain teams, that difference in experience allows them to push regardless of which side they start on. They'll be able to get the momentum that carries them through and gets them a couple of rounds on their side, gets them that cushion early on. So it looks like 3D Max will be starting on the CT side here, so they will have the slight advantage going into it. The one question is, are they going to be able to deal with that aggression that's going to be coming out from LDLC? I mean, Kyoshima on point, just leading the charge. They need to be on point with their crossfire setups over on these sites.
They definitely do. And just it feels like the calm before the storm here. Stage looking really, really good, by the way, here. It's about time we got Counter-Strike into Globen, right?
Damn, it's been too long. Damn straight. On the main stage here, Friday afternoon. Beautiful day outside as well for Sweden.
It's not as bad as it could have been, definitely. And LDLC going for a pretty fast moving up here, but it's not a straight rush. They do have the bomb, so I think actually if they get an opening kill, they are going to collapse on this bomb side, and that would actually be a little bit difficult. There's almost four people here on 3D Max. They have a decent setup, the Finnish team, to deal with any kind of incoming rush here.
Now they've got three guys, one in connector in mid as well. He's going to be able to rotate over fairly quickly on short, but it's going to be Caron behind Forklift looking for the shot. He's not quite able to find it. Forklift actually getting in the way, and Kyoshima will open it up. First blood here in this match. And it's already looking like LDLC are going to get control of this site.
Yeah, bomb has not been planted yet, but it doesn't really matter because they're coming out on top in the kill department. And right now it's a 2-on-3. Smith's is kind of low, and now the bomb's finally being put down. The Frenchman really taking their time, and Reflex has to win this battle in the middle. That's absolutely key. Waiting for it a little bit. The P2000, not a bad weapon, but Shoxi is an exceptional pistol player. We'll pick up that first headshot, and now it's disturbed in a 1-on-3, and this should be an unwinnable position. They keep challenging him, which actually maybe is going to give him a bit of a chance, but he's going to get backstabbed as well. Shoxi comes in with an LDLC arc to pick up that first round.
Yeah, very fine, Don. I mean, that was the thing. Once they managed to get control, they never really let it go. And then putting Shoxi in mid also was just so smart, managing to keep anybody from closing in and getting a pincer movement on the CT side, coming up short and coming up through CT. So Shoxi winning that duel was just crucial. After that, it's a triangle of doom, and LDLC are able to clean up. But now going into the second round, the question is, do 3D Max actually go for an armor buy or not? And they're not going to. So this tells us they really want to have as much money as possible in the fourth round buy.
Yeah, plus I think armor is less needed on a map like Cash. And by the way, they're also going for a stack, so that means there's even less of a reason for it. But on Cash, you can generally rely on the terrorists getting pretty close to you. So if you have, you know, the C sets like two of them have, or a 5-7 or anything like that, you know, you hit a headshot or you don't, but either way, the guy's gonna die or you're gonna die. The armor won't make that big a difference.
LDLC have done their homework. This is a play that 3D Max went for in the second round as well versus Fnatic on this map. So, Natu does manage to catch Shoxi off guard. He's at 75 headshot to the face, and that's what's so dangerous about coming around corners. When you get up close like that, you can just be gone instantly. So it's a 4-on-4 now with LDLC having that bomb site under control. It's going to be Reflex actually getting boosted up into mid, so you could look for an angle here to work, but nobody's lurking around here for LDLC.
And a lot of patience on the Finnish side as well. They almost find Happy there. Reflex being boosted around, and there's going to be Caron taking down Happy. So that's two rifles being stolen here. And they're playing a really patient game, the Finns. They're not just hunting for kills, looking for whatever they can. As a second one comes in, Disturbed's going to take down Kiyoshima. That is a hugely successful round. They pick up all rifles that they got taken away there. So three rifles saved for 3D Max. I actually wouldn't be surprised if they go for a force up on the rest here. That would not be a bad move.
That would, exactly. Somebody can drop. They can drop two guns here. They've got three rifles to fall on, and they're going to be able to get some nades as well. So LDLC all of a sudden are going to be under a lot of pressure early on here. 3D Max, there you go. Full rifles, good nade count as well. And already LDLC getting a fight one round early.
Yeah, very nicely done. And Smith is going to go down, taking the challenge against two people who are really aggressively pushed up, and they're going to go and check for more. So not only do they kill Smiths, but they get the information that nobody else is over on that side of the map. And Shoxi's making his way out here. Reflex going to take down Kiyoshima. Shoxi looking for the kill, but he's looking the wrong way. He's going to get taken down by Natu. This is looking fantastic for 3D Max. Another kill comes in. Just straight headshots all around here from the counter-terrorist team. And NBK, 1-on-5, no chance at all to do this.
No, he has to be. I mean, he's on the hunt at this point. He's just looking to see if he can catch anybody out of position. But 3D Max, they know that they've got the bomb carrier. Happy was carrying it over in A main. So all they have to do is just close in on that bomb, and they're going to run into NBK eventually. And it looks like Corona's raiding around the corner. He's going to find NBK, and there you go. 3D Max, just fine style here. They're managing to actually make this work very nicely.
All right. So, yes, I mean, Thorin did say, if you are playing in a best of three game and you're the underdog, best thing to do is come out guns blazing and win in a 2-0 fashion. And picking up three kills in the eco round and then forcing a buy and then having a flawless round to follow with and forcing your opponent to eco doesn't really get any better than that.
NBK is going to have the scout at mid, so now we have to see if is he quick enough to land it on Xart. Xart is waiting around the corner in connector. There's the shot. Xart hands he has the headshot first. So things not going to work out here for LDLC. They need to pick that scout back up again, and it's going to be Smith picking it this time. But LDLC, in the meantime, is starting to close in around this A site. They're looking to see if they can't gather up and just YOLO the man down.
And on the 3D Max side, there's a little bit of movement going on, but they are playing it really coolly here. They're not panicked, they're not scared, they're just holding their positions and waiting for LDLC to make the move, and they will make that move. That's a really great double kill from Shox. That CSET 75 coming into play big time. And now the bomb is going to go down as well. Reflex moving up the middle. This could turn around for LDLC.
Yeah, firepower is here, however, 3D Max, and they haven't wasted too much time getting over to this side of the map as well, so already got oversight there. They're going to pin the man down behind, and that Smith's getting picked off. He had that gun, but it's going to be Happy now with this AK looking for an angle to work. Kiyoshima, peekaboo, finds Xart, and now Reflex, the only man alive here in a 1v3, and he's on this site, manages to pick up two big kills. It's all down to Kiyoshima now, trying to play the time. Reflex with the fake bait. Kiyoshima, he's playing this perfectly. Reflex has no time, even if he gets the kill here. And he may have even done enough damage to take him with the bomb.
Yeah, very nicely done there. And yeah, he just had he had exactly the angle to just go and peek and see that the fuse wasn't actually a committal, that he just faked it once. So yeah, 3D Max, unfortunately for them, losing a round that was just based off of one scout and a couple of pistols. CSET 75 in the hand of Shoxi is looking terrifying.
And Shoxi looks focused as well when we get him on camera. He always looks focused, that's the thing. This guy, one of the best players in the world. We're definitely going to be looking to him for the right calls, but also for a big performance here. And 3D Max, luckily for them, they have enough money to go for a pretty big buy here, so it's still going to be four guys with rifles, which is actually quite good here. LDLC, however, going for the map control. They're just spread out across this map, looking to see if they can't find anybody peeking on 3D Max's side. Smith with this AWP over on B is going to get smoked off, though. That's going to slow things down a little bit here.
3D Max going with pretty much the same setup they had for a long time. I'm wondering if that one guy, you know, there's nobody in the vent, so actually they're just holding checkered and the B inside the B bomb site, and then that seems to be their preferred setup here. I'm wondering if they're going to change it later on in the game. We'll see. But LDLC are getting a lot of mid control because of the relaxed defense here from the CT side in the middle.
They are getting a lot of mid-control, but still 3D Max willing to give them that, it seems. They've rotated Corona over onto short to make sure that the defense is going to be strong enough here on the A site, but they are focusing on B, and 3D Max know that checkers is going to be a very dangerous position for them, and they're actually going for a very clever play here, 3D Max. This could work against LDLC. Disturbed is going to start off strong and pick up the first frag, but it's going to be the push hard through the smoke from LDLC, trying to get out onto the site, but Corona, he's already caught them out.
Yeah, they do take out Natsu in the back of the site, so there's something going on here for LDLC. It's still a 4-on-3, and with the bomb down, they're not in such a bad position, especially with Happy getting that kill. That was Disturbed coming up from behind. Now, they've got to move quick with 3D Max, because otherwise they're going to get sandwiched, and they could be sandwiched in really quickly here. Kiyoshima doing a little bit of damage, and it's going to be Karon coming in, not choosing the forklift route, and maybe that was a mistake. Sart is going to take down Shoxi, but now this 1-on-2 for Reflex is very hard. All the Frenchmen have to do is just not show themselves, and yeah, he's going to have to back up. He has no choice.
Oh, even getting that parting shot. Kiyoshima will hunt him down. No save here. And LDLC will pick up that round. But no save again here for 3D Max. That's going to be a bit painful for them. Their money can't be in too good a spot right now. They're definitely going to be communicating what went right, what went wrong in that situation. I think you're right, though. Disturbed on that flank, him getting picked off, did a lot to hurt 3D Max's retake. They had a potential pincer movement there, just retaking that site, and it just fell apart once he was gone.
Yeah, and it makes you wonder if the people coming in from middle and over from the truck should have been the first guys pushing in, and then Disturbed should have been there once that battle was going on. Instead, it seemed like it kind of ended up being Disturbed initiating, but it was also a result of the LDLC player pushing quite far down to find him. So, yeah, just all around good round from LDLC. 4-1 is the scoreline, and into the sixth round, it's going to be 3D Max on an eco. Happy waiting over by the squeak door, and they know by now that it's an eco, so yeah, LDLC, I think they're feeling good right now.
They have to be feeling pretty confident. The bomb is still dropped around, but Smith is going to find the entry over on Reflex. And now it's going to be Natsu taking a little bit of damage. The remaining members here for 3D Max. Happy eventually gets overwhelmed. His swag impression, not quite there. But this means that LDLC have control of the B side at this point. So they're going to be able to get the bomb over here, ferry it over fairly quickly, and get that bomb plant down. 3D Max, however, they have an AK to hold on to now, so that's good for Karon. He can actually hold on to that if he wants. Whereas the rest of them can just kind of get in position and poke at LDLC, make sure they're on their toes.
Yeah, but he's not running that far away, actually. Karon's going to go down with the AK, so they were trying to do something. I think they got wallbanged, actually, down from Checkered. He was trying to wallbang the other way. Yeah, so there it is. He was trying to shoot through, and they just had more firepower on the other side, unfortunately.
Oops. That's a bit awkward, but they are going to be able to make it out of there intact. It's going to be a start just getting picked off here. No real opposition, and damage done to LDLC, but no real big kills coming in. So this AK is like the best case scenario right now for 3D Max. You know, they only get one kill, but at least they get a gun out of the trade, and maybe they can do something clever with it in the next round if they decide to force up, because I don't think they're going to have enough money to be able to go for that big buy where they can get everything they want here on 3D Max.
Now, the big question is if it's worth it for them to eco around and then go for it. That's a big risk. You got to remember, I mean, LDLC are a team that played the CT side of this map pretty well too, so they don't need that many rounds, and they're already looking good. So maybe they just want to see if they can't find their way in here with normal rifles, and yeah, that's the play.
Yeah, that could have been Natsu. Actually, Natsu getting fully equipped, so I don't think he actually had to drop there, but it's going to be 3D Max getting a bit scared. I think that's the question here, is that 3D Max, are they going to be able to actually slow LDLC down enough? They need to basically put a halt to LDLC right here. Five rounds is where LDLC need to stop for 3D Max. It has to be 3D Max picking up the rest of these rounds in this half, so that's what's prompting this buy.
Molotovs and everything. They are going to try and burn out the 3D Max members in this bomb site and then just rush in. They're going to come in from two different angles, and now it's on. Karon here by the forklift has to come up pretty big. He's looking for the shot. He's going to miss the initial one, and maybe Cable take a kill, and Shotzi to follow up, and that is not the initial defense that they were looking for here. Disturbed actually does get a good kill in, but they're out of their own bomb site, and there's still plenty of grenades left here on LDLC to try and keep them away for a little while longer.
Yeah, a couple of flashes are definitely going to be making this a little bit complicated. There's a smoke on Reflex. We'll have to see if he can find an angle to use that. But right now, it's Disturbed getting overwhelmed. Sart gets caught as well. Smith with a double kill to clean this push-up, and 3D Max once again going to be in a position where they have to back off and just try and hold on to the guns. It's all about maintaining these rifles now for 3D Max because they just don't have enough money to buy. LDLC, however, they're not wasting any time. They know exactly what's happened. And they are going to not allow him to hold on to this gun. As best they can, they don't want to let him just save this kind of money. There you go. MBK finds him at the very end.
He was even looking the wrong way. So a really incredible run-and-gun type moment for MBK. Now, the defense wasn't so good in that A-bomb site, and one of the reasons was that while Karon was holding pretty close to the forklift, he could have actually been holding even closer to the wall, which means he would have been in a blind angle for them coming in. But his teammate was all the way at the back of the other side of the site, so they weren't actually able to help each other out that much. And that effect was kind of multiplied by the fact that LDLC threw so many grenades that there was absolutely no way they were going to be able to help each other out. So yeah, they had two people initially in the bomb site, but they were playing alone anyway.
Yeah, it was a bit of a shame as well, because Karon had an opportunity there to land at least one frag. because the smokes, the flashes, everything actually kind of avoided Forklift, which really surprised me when LDLC went for that push. They completely ignored Forklift when none of their things had worked to actually flash or cut that guy off. So it was a bit of a blind spot in LDLC there, and 3DMax weren't able to jump on it. Right now, LDLC and this anti-eco round are doing pretty well. They've managed to pick up 3 kills, and they've only lost Smiths. Happy just barely hanging in there.
Disturbed. Yeah. I picked up 1 kill on Smiths because he was hiding in Checker, but it doesn't last forever. And now Corona going to be walking right in to Kiyoshima, and actually he almost takes him down. Some good pistol work. But there's really no disguising at this point that LDLC are off to a very, very strong start here. 7-1 is, that's terrifying.
That's looking very good for the Frenchman. You're right. I mean, this is still a bit of a CT map. I mean, it can go either way. Reflex and his lads 3DMax can come right back into it. Look at this. Corona's doing great damage. It's only going to be 2 remaining members here for LDLC. You have to almost hide, but look at where Corona's running. He's never going to expect this. He's running right back into them. Oh, he spots the man out at Squeak Door just in the nick of time.
Oh, they were waiting for him all over. I'm not sure if they were trying to hide or if they were setting up a trap, but either way, it works out great for them. They do exactly both, so 7-1. We're going to have to see something different here from the Finnish team. And actually, something they haven't gone for it. They've gone for it the one round that they won, which was the aggression over on B side, where they caught Smiths off. That was really good. So you got to wonder if they want to try and emulate that. They don't have to do the B if they want. So you can go aggressive all over this map. You could do it at the main entrance. You could do it by Squeak Door. You could, even if you wanted to, we've seen that in the middle of the map as well. Xart, and there it is, slightly aggressive setup. So that's a good idea. He does miss the shot, and he's going to go down. That's Happy wall banging through the wall. Very cool stuff, man. Natu with a very important double return.
Wow, yeah, Natu stepping in, and Corona as well. Natu saving the day. That looked like a perfect opening there for LDLC to jump on this A site. Happy with the wallbang too. Sick way to get the entry there. But it's going to be this third picking up Shoxi, who is snooping around mid, and is now just Happy having to back off. So 1v4 situation here in LDLC. It looked like they were in a great position to just jump on that A site and get the bomb plant down, but Natu decided to stop that from happening.
Happy's going to go down, so... Yeah, worked out really well for 3DMax, and they're going to pick up a second round. I wish I could claim that it was because of the aggression, but it probably wasn't. If anything, it was just, I think, maybe LDLC thought once they killed Xart coming in there, they wanted so badly to get in, and then they ran right into Natu. That's put a big stop to it. So, yeah, I still like the fact that 3DMax tried it. I want to see more slightly aggressive moves.
I'm just really speeding things up. I mean, they still have the AWP for Xart, so this is going to be good damage for him. He's actually looking towards B. Curious to see if he's going to start pushing a bit forward to find an angle into Garage and try and close that. Right now, LDLC are actually prepared for any kind of aggression coming out. They've fallen actually quite back. They're still kind of floating around T-spawn back of Garage, and these are positions you take when you expect a team to go aggressive, but somehow Smith still walks into them.
Wow, Xart was pushed up really far, almost all by the playground there, so... I mean, that is really, really important. That's exactly what worked for them the first time around. So, I love it.
And in A main as well, there's a double here for 3DMax. So this is looking like a real aggression coming out here from 3DMax. They're looking to see if they can't really catch LDLC off guard, but then NBK and Shoxi come in and get 2 big frags. It's going to open things up here. I mean, we already have the rotation coming out here from Caron. He's going to get flashed in. Great opportunity there. Gets what? Nearly gets the second, but Shoxi shuts him down, and Shoxi gets the double. That clears up A site, and now it's just down to start with the AWP.
Not exactly the best weapon to try and retake a bomb site with, but he's going to try anyway. He does catch out Kiyoshima. And Happy and Shoxi is still left, and actually he's controlling the bomb here, so how are they going to deal with this? They have a Molotov and a grenade. Walks in, and oh, he misses the shot. That could have been a big opening. And LDLC back on tracks again. That wasn't impossible for him to win.
No, definitely not. I mean, when he hits the bomb carrier on short, the bomb drops right in the middle. If they don't have a smoke or a flash to block him off, it comes down to the shots. So that was a big opportunity there to just turn it around for 3DMax. Potential 1v3 clutch could have happened, but now it's going to be LDLC. Fully bought. 3DMax have just enough to put something together. It's Disturbed! Pro 90, what's up? Infinite bullets! 2 kills at mid.
MBK and Kiyoshima weren't counting on that. And that's a really, really nice start. Now they just need to play it safely again. I mean, you want to play aggressive early to get those kills to catch the opponent off guard, but afterwards you can play it safer, except for Corona landing a sick headshot on Happy. And now Smith and Shoxi. Best case is they take a bunch of rifles away. And if they could put down the bomb, that'd be even better, but...
Well, Smith landing a great shot there on Corona. Manages to keep his cool. He takes a lot of damage in the exchange, though, so that's certainly not going to help odds here for LDLC. And 3D Max are now going to put a little bit more attention towards this A site. So this is a smart play from here from 3D Max. Just play the numbers. They are getting a little bit cheeky on the other side of the map, and we're going to have to see if that's going to work out for them now. Smith's coming in.
Reflex is in a brilliant position here. That's the one that's a double spray down. Very, very nicely handled. Good movement coming out here. Seeing the play happening, at least Tender actually did. 3D Max picking up another round. And what is actually the most upsetting thing about the current situation in this first half is that it feels to me like 3D Max actually had a pretty good formula for how to stop LDLC. They just forgot about it for too many rounds in a row. And now they've sort of picked up on it again. So I feel like the scoreline could have been a little bit different if they had made the adjustment earlier. But these 8-round trail DLC is already plenty for the French team.
Again, it comes back to that underdog thing, right? You know, they just have to go crashing into them and basically just beat them down immediately right at the start. And then LDLC, if they get any time to regain their composure and start putting that experience to work, it's going to look a bit like this. What's up, Natu? 1-for-1 trade over by Forklift. It's going to be Corone still alive on this A site, though. Manages to cut down one, and he's still alive. Sard has now rotated in from CT with that AWP. Picks up a frag, and this is down to Happy now. Last man alive, and Corone, he just seems to know. He's lobbing nades right on his head.
It's not exactly clear where Happy's going to want to go from here either. Without the bomb and without any grenades or anything, it's just a matter of time before they realize he's there. And now they do. Flashbang draining, and Happy's gone. Corone picks up that last kill. And 3D Max, yeah, they're starting to gear up a little bit more. If they do finish this first half at an 8-7 fashion, that wouldn't be unmanageable. I still think because they're the underdog team and because they're playing a really strong LDLC team, I'd much rather have to seen them finish 9-6 to make it a really favorable first half for themselves. But 8-7 isn't it. You can recover from that.
8-7, you can. I mean, you pick up that pistol, you start getting momentum going on your side. When you switch over to the offense, to the offensive, right? 3D Max, they've shown that they're absolutely capable of picking up entry frags and then speeding up. And that's the very core here, is that they're a very quick team on their feet. They love to be aggressive and get in their opponent's faces. And Reflex and Disturb just cutting them down in droves. LDLC getting overwhelmed. And a perfect anti-eco there for 3D Max. Bouncing back into this game. And now they just need to continue picking up rounds like this, Anders. If they do finish 8-7, they are definitely not out of this.
Oh, very nicely done, and they're well on their way. I think LDLC just have one more buy in them here. If they're going to lose the upcoming round, I mean, they're going to be buying now. If they lose the next one, they're going to be coming again. So, 8-7 is definitely not out of the question at this point. And it is Caron top fragging right now, I think, for 3D Max. So, doing a fine job here on cash. And let's see. Setup is a little bit different this time for 3D Max. You can see they're pushing quite aggressively. Actually, three people over here in B. So they're going back to that style again, and I love it. Flashbang in, now they're going to push out, and oh, it backfires on them. Kiyoshima and Smith, they were ready for it. So you've got to wonder if that became too predictable now. I think Ixart's the only one holding the B bomb site, alone with an AWP. It's a pretty tough task, and he's going to miss that first shot. Now to kill him background. Ixart will pick up one. It's still a 2-on-3. It's not over yet. And they are going to fall back. They have some respect for him, and now 2 in the middle is going to pick up Happy. It's all the way back to a 2-on-2. Nicely done, 3D Max.
Yeah, this is still a scary situation, though, because wherever LDLC are sticking together at this point, this is the smart play to make. And if they get around this corner, it should be a 1-for-1 trade, and Natu is going to go down. We're into that 1v1 situation now. Kiyoshima with 2 kills. No smoke to cut off CT to make his life easier, and he's going to be able to get onto the site just in the nick of time. Question is now, does he see where XR is going to come from?
No, he ducks. They actually both duck to miss each other. Xant's going to walk up here. Can he get the kill? One more click, and he does it! Fantastic play from 3D Max. They win the round. That was so close. Those two opening kills over at B should have been plenty for LDLC to make it all the way through. The bomb plant is going to give LDLC a slightly better round to end off with here in the first half, but I still think their economy is not going to be great. Oh, man. And Natu, the fact is, Natu could have had a double spray down in the middle. He could have killed both.
You saw him run out of bullets there with the M4A1.
Yeah.
One of the things. You know, pew-pew lasers are great, but you're 10 down on bullets in the mag compared to the unsilenced version of that rifle. So sometimes you will see these spray situations. Just
look at the money here. They have very few grenades. If they hadn't got that bomb plant, those wouldn't have been AKs. Those would have been Galils instead. That is how much that bomb plant actually mattered for LDLC. They sneak in another buy round.
Yeah, they just barely manage it, but they still actually get a good number of smokes and flashes here as well. They can go for a play here on the A side if they wanted to. They have enough to be able to cut off CT, cut off short, and put a little bit of pressure there in the back. But look at the way the 3D Max are holding. They're getting really far back here, just letting Sart find the angle. And there you go. The entry frag picks off Smith.
Yeah, Smith thought he was going to be able to put down a free smoke then, but he wasn't. And now in the corner, Natu does get taken down, and that loses them some of the control. But in the meantime, Xart moving up close with the orb, takes another kill, looking for a third. He's going to pre-fire a little bit and misses the shot, gets a third one. Can we see a quad kill from Xart? Really close to it, but not quite. Shoxi's going to take him down. Molotov in here is going to block off the site a little bit. Reflex will drop Happy, and now it's all on Shoxi. This grenade is the touchdown, and Shoxi is gone. 7-8, 3D Max. Yesterday, the performance they had against Copenhagen Wolves and Dignitas, it wasn't just a fluke, it wasn't just that. They've definitely come back and proven themselves here. And again, if they'd made the adjustment to play aggressively earlier when LDLC were winning, this could have been a very different score. But still, 8-7, they can do it. They can still do it.
Oh, they certainly can, man. We can't count them out yet by any stretch. If they can pick up the pistol here in the second half. Same thing, though, going into this. So LDLC, it's not like they haven't done their homework. They know what's going to be going on here with 3D Max. The 3D Max are going to want to be very quick on their feet and put aggression in fast. And so now going into this match, the game plan for LDLC has to be, we can't let them set up. We can't let them get in comfortable positions. We have to shut them down before they can allow it to get anything going for themselves here. Because we've got a lot of firepower on our side as well. So I'm curious to see if we're going to see them go for the kind of aggressive style that 3D Max showed here towards the end of the first half.
I doubt it. I think LDLC are going to want to play this really standard early on just to get a feel for how 3D Max are going to react to that. But they actually are moving up really, just like 3D Max were, really aggressively over by the B side and looking to find somebody. But, 3D Max have the setup. The fact that it's even been spotted out all of a sudden means LDLC should probably give up on this venture. And, well, they could stick around playground, but they shouldn't keep forcing it.
No, exactly. They're going to rotate around to mid and see if they can't find a weakness here. And it's going to be one man holding in mid like that. Shoxi getting tagged down a little bit, playing that key position in the rotator role. Seems like he wants to try and lend a hand over at B site, and that's going to be the good call. Smith will find the headshot, though. He's alive and toxic, and he's trying to put some shots out. He's caught in the corner as well, or his mate's going to make it here in time. He's still doing damage. This is not good. Smith with two kills and a lot of tagged up people on 3D Max.
And it took such a long time to kill him that actually the rotation is already in place from LDLC. And 3D Max are weighing their options right now. If they wait enough time, maybe some of the LDLC members are going to rotate back, but this is not enough. If they push within the next 5 seconds, LDLC is still going to be here, but you can see one of them moving back now. So they've waited enough to get one guy to leave, the rest are still here. And it's going to be still a tough 2-on-3 in this bomb site before the backup even shows up. That's a great opening, though. Disturbed with a stunning headshot in the background. Kiyoshima's going to go down. That's Karon with the headshot. Now they smoked off Happy. They're going to get a bomb plant, and they have a one-man advantage. That is huge.
Yeah, they are tagged. That's one thing to keep in mind here. But if they play this smart, the Triangle of Doom is going to be set up for 3D Max. They've got the man on the site. MBK, he will find the man holding by Checkered, though. That's going to open things up. He's single-handedly pulling onto this site and getting all the frags with that 5-7. Big damage going out here to Karon, who's pinned down behind the box, and he can't live through it. LDLC, the remaining two members, will retake the site with enough time for the defuse.
And that's actually the critical thing. Nobody had a kit picked up right now on LDLC, so if they had stayed alive just a little bit longer, if they had got one guy maybe into the back of Checkered who could play the clock a little bit more, maybe this could have worked out. It's still impressive that 3D Max even got into that 2-on-3 situation, but MBK just single-handedly taking care of business here.
Yeah, really nice entry there onto the B site. Picking off Shoxi like that with Disturbed was very well done, and Karon with the second one as well. So it definitely shows that 3D Max, you know, you can't give them even a little bit of time to find their composure, because as soon as they can refine their center and just kind of calm down and get in that game zone right, that's what happens. They give you a big scare. And LDLC, now they have that in the back of their heads. Now we actually see them playing a little bit more casually here.
Well, there's actually a really good chance that if they... Oh, now backup is here. But if they'd rush straight away, yeah, like just like they did now, if they drop the MBK that quick, they can't get in and put the bomb down. There was a weakness at that bomb sign for LDLC. It's been minimized a little bit by Smith rotating here quickly. So that's a really good job from LDLC getting in position. But they're still losing a couple of players here. And Smith is damn near dead as well. The bomb has been planted and... With a bomb kill, a bomb plant, and another kill coming in from Reflex. Two kills and a bomb plant. Good job from 3D Max again.
Yeah, that's a solid follow-up round there. That's a big win for them. Could put some pressure on in this next round as well. They haven't really spent too much money in this one. So there are options for 3D Max now going forward. Are they going to be able to have enough to go for a consistent buy?
LDLC
giving up two guys, but still getting the round.
They got the bomb plant in both rounds, so they're definitely going to be going for it here. The question is if they're going to be going for an AWP on the terrorist side, which is less common on cash. Wouldn't really mind if they do, and they are going to go for it. Yeah,
they're going to go for it. I was wondering if they were going to risk the glass cannon, but it doesn't seem like that's a problem for them. I mean, AWP, you're supposed to hit first, right? Then reflexes like lightning.
Reflex moving up. There are two people, and the smoke is on here, but they can just wait the smoke out. That's not a big problem for them. And see if LDLC do become a little bit more aggressive. But they're playing it actually passively all over the map here, the Frenchmen. Except for this. Kiyoshima with the boost. Look at this sexy play coming out here from the French team. If they move just an inch back, it's going to be a free kill here. And Ixart, oh, somehow Kiyoshima missing. That should have been an easy kill. And now 3D match, yeah, they're going to say, all right, if you're playing sloppy in this bomb site, we'll come and kill you. Flashbang come in, grenade does rain out into the middle, and 3D Max are still slowing up. Looked like they wanted to go straight into it.
That was really scary. In the meantime, LDLC, they're getting into clever positions here on the A site. So if 3D Max were to rotate back around, they could be running into a very, very difficult position to deal with here. LDLC happy in that position is going to be crucial. Disturbed is going to be causing a bit of a diversion over here to make sure that LDLC don't feel too comfortable. But they're actually coming to them. NBK walks right into one, picks him up, does the job for Kiyoshima, and gets the second frag as well.
Caught trying to boost in that corner. Flashbang goes out. MBK is very nearly dead, but they're going to have to find him before they can do anything about it here. And MBK getting on. Well, that Smith's actually taking it, but MBK doing a lot of damage as well and almost able to get that frag. But now it's falling apart for 3D Max. They were trying to set up, and that's the worst time to get caught. And Shoxi will finish it off. So LDLC do win the round. And that's a big problem for 3D Max. They've invested a lot into it.
Yeah, I'm liking to see this this very quick play coming out from LDLC as well. They're not throwing away players needlessly. Every time somebody gets caught, it's the other one stepping in to pick up that slack. So NBK getting caught first there, but Smith's instantly stepping in to manage to pick up a frag of his own. No idea how Kiyoshima missed that shot there on Xart.
Yeah, that was such a beautiful idea, and it's the kind of trick you can really only use, I mean, even sometimes just once per tournament, because every other team is going to be ready for that. Smith will take down Reflex, and obviously there is an eco round coming out here from the Finnish team. Now, four rounds behind.
Struggling somewhat. They are getting fairly close here. Nice nade to go in, but it's not going to blind Shoxi. This is a very common position for Shoxi to play in as well, but it's going to be Kiyoshima picking up that frag. Natu has been removed. Happy alive on this A side is going to drop this, he's going to drop the push with NBK there to stop it, and he's going to close the door behind him. NBK.
Yeah, nice casual pickoff. Makes it look like that he just does that every time, right? Plenty of money now on the Finnish side. Let's see if they can get back into it. There's a good distribution of kills on the LDLC side. Nobody really slacking far behind. And Smith's actually top fragging, which is not the usual, not the usual distribution.
No, that's true. He's stepping it up here. I mean, we look to LDLC. There's just, as we were saying, you know, in the match warm-up, right? When we were talking over these teams, there's so much experience on both of these teams that anybody can really step to the fore. That's the power of LDLC. Anybody can really step to the fore and be that man for the match. And so it seems like LDLC, Shoxi, they're kind of splitting the difference right now. 3D Max, at the same time, not lagging too far behind either. So this is still very close. LDLC, they're going to have to weather the storm here on the A site, and the bomb leads for 3D Max.
That's a nice opening. MBK's the first man to go down. Molotov in the back here. Smith might have to find a new home. He's just in between them. And he does pick up a kill on Natu. Now they're going to try and find him, but Kiyoshima's here. Happy's there with the kill. And now the Finns are in a little bit of a trouble here. They're already the backup is there, and Happy will pick up a second kill, leaving Reflex alone. Really, really quick rotation coming in from LDLC. That was almost perfect from the CT side.
They've just closed in on all angles, but Reflex, he's in this position where he can do some damage. He manages to catch them peeking, and Happy making a bit of a crucial mistake there. Smoke to go down as well, and that baits him out in the open. Shoxi making sure that Reflex couldn't take advantage of that smoke to get on that bomb.
Reflex got the last bullet there when he was flashed and just, you know, getting ready to reload. He walked into it. Can't believe it. That's such a close round. It's almost a 1-on-3 for Reflex then. That would have been the turnaround point, right? That's where 3D Max get the confidence back. Now instead, yeah. LDLC are very close to actually taking this first map here. If they can just win one more round, they're going to force the eco once again on the 3D Max side, and then things start to get really ugly. Now, are they going to try and see if they can catch Kiyoshima? The smoke's already up here. He's got a grenade in hand. He's down to three, and the grenade to follow. Now, Shoxi alone inside the bomb site. Backup's coming, but they're going to smoke it off, and Shoxi goes down. The aggression working beautifully here for 3D Max, and it's NBK and Happy left. 2-on-5. So from a really, you know, some a couple of disappointing rounds straight into a flawless round.
Yeah, and they're figuring it out. This is the thing. They're going to start mapping out how LDLC are holding on this map. Even with some of the aggressive pokes coming out here from LDLC, their B site is still very static. A lot of the time, it is Kiyoshima or Shoxi holding in that checkered position. And it seems like 3D Max, they were in position to be able to take care of that this time. Nades to bombard him into oblivion, and then they get onto that site fairly quickly after that.
Well, and it's also a question of timing, ultimately. If they had decided to if they decided to throw that push in one of the rounds where LDLC were playing aggressively, probably a very different result altogether. But they did it exactly a round where they were playing passively in check, and then it works out a lot better.
Mm. All right, let's see how things shape up here. Already LDLC getting some good exit frags, though. That's not too shabby. That's going to force 3D Max to spend money that they can ill afford to spend. So see what the Finns actually have in store for us here in this round, as we can see them on the stage here live from the Globe Arena, one of the biggest arenas in Sweden. So it's so sick to have CS on the main stage here. But now, let's see, LDLC three rounds away from picking up this first map in the best of three. This is the first semifinal of the day. Ooh. They're looking good. Shoxi, he's got that AWP, and he's looking for an angle to work here. He could potentially have a target, and there it is.
I think that's LDLC way of saying, all right, we got to change it up a little bit here. We got to do something else. And yeah, Shoxi with an orb is not a bad way to change the game and to change the pace a little bit now. Wonder where Shoxi, he's still sticking over there, which is, I guess, all right. He's going to go down to Assad, though. Really nice AK shot, and I don't know. I think it would have been more interesting if LDLC had put Shoxi in a different place for each kill he got, just to keep L3D Max guessing where he might be. But I don't think Sard got that kill because he knew. That was just really a nice nice reaction shot.
Yeah, he manages to just get the information. I mean, it's like 60% chance that Shoxi's going to be there. Just throwing that number out there. But that is really one of Shoxi's favorite places to hold from, regardless of whether it's an AWP or an AK. So
Now they have an interesting play with the guy up in vents here. Smith's just in the vents, and they got one guy inside the bomb site. So it's going to be down to communication and timing here. If 3D Max go for B, but right now, it feels like it's going to be an A play, and there's not a lot of time left here. This is almost some Na'Vi-style slow play coming out from the Finnish team. And eventually, yeah, look at this MVK thinking he's going to walk to the other side. That's because Sart's making noise, but now they got the kill. They're going to go back here, and Happy will pick up the 1 second kill coming in. The bomb is dropped as well, and 3D Max can't make it work. It was actually very close, because as soon as Exile started making movement, you could see MBK was falling back to try and help out quick. And I don't know, if the timing had been slightly better for 3D Max, they might have walked into a bomb site with only two people holding. Mm-hmm.
But again, Happy, this time around, it works perfectly, this position. This is how it's supposed to go for him. If they come rushing out from A main, he's going to slaughter them. If they come pushing up from short, though, he gets spotted from a mile away, and that position falls apart. So it works out great for LDLC this time, and it looks like 3D Max are going to be ecoing this one as well. But Reflex already pinning Shoxi down in the corner. Shoxi's going to get two, and it's actually Kiyoshima who is stuck behind the box.
Not looking good here. It's going to be map point any second now. 3D Max at 8, and LDLC at 15, so if they take another round here, that's it. So the Finnish team, best case, they win 7 rounds in a row and force the overtime. And we did see a couple of overtimes yesterday, but or almost, actually. We saw one, but I think the Nip Titan game almost went to overtime if it wasn't for Kenny and his nonsense.
Yeah, that was, I mean, it was just Kenny from that position in Element. How does he land that shot, Anders? This is just disgusting. All right, but we'll see more of that later. Titan coming up in the second semifinal of the day versus Fnatic, the Swedish team here at DreamHack. But yes, that is LDLC in front of you, and it is LDLC now in game. Smith's going to be holding in front of the boost spot from short, and that's not the best position for him to be in right now. He could get caught out in the open, unless he can find the angle here on 3D Max, but Caron steps out and gets him first.
It's 3-on-3, not looking too bad here. Natsu picking up a good kill right at the end. Kiyoshima is actually going to be walking out on the other side of the smoke, trying to see if he can pick up a kill before it pops, but he's going to be falling back instead, and now Shoxi's walking up behind them, and this is going to crumble the attack. Actually, Shoxi missing a lot of shots, but it doesn't really matter. MBK on the other side, and they do get sandwiched in. LDLC are going to take the first map, 16-8 on cash. I feel like that again, I mean, we've been using this line a lot recently, but it feels like that's one of those deceptive score lines, right? You have 16-8, it seems like it's very one-sided. But 3D Max had a lot more openings than they made use of, essentially.
Yeah, they did. I mean, it also took them a little bit of time to figure out, as we were saying, you know, throughout that first half, to figure out exactly how to counter LDLC and stop them from getting momentum early. It took them a little bit longer than expected. They did catch up and ended up at 8-7, but going into the second half, it does seem like LDLC, well, had them dialed in. You know, there was a couple rocky rounds there where LDLC got caught from the outright 3D Max aggression, and that's the thing that LDLC were trying to predict going into this game. They're like, okay, we know they're very quick on their feet. We know they love to just get that entry and then speed up right behind it. So they needed to deal with that, and they did so, well, very well, because they picked up the first map eventually. But now we're back here at the desk. Thorin, let's hear your opinion. What did you think about the LDLC's
performance? Yeah, I agree with what you said about it being a deceptive scoreline, actually, because if you look at the score, you think, oh, very convincing, like, wasn't much of a game. But okay, the only rounds the Finns really got was on the first half, and then they kind of like, they were too late to be aggressive and do what actually worked for them. But on the other half there, even though LDLC did close it out by the numbers in the second half, I actually thought the Finns were pretty good, actually. The LDLC looked a bit hesitant sometimes. Meanwhile, the Finns were actually like getting kills. They were getting them. They got into a lot of like 1-on-X situation, 2-on-X situations.
Yeah, that's the thing.
In the end, that's what you see. Like when you have a lineup like the LDLC line with that quality of players, like they're going to pull through in those scenarios. You really need some miracles if you're going to win like 1-on-2s against superior players. And I think that's what you saw. LDLC, they didn't like outplay the team in terms of like a team versus team, but their individual players were stronger. You saw there was no one on the Finnish team who could just go totally crazy. They had their odd rounds, but they couldn't all step up as a team.
And that second half pistol, where they ended up in the B bomb site, and they actually got in there and got the kills, even though it looked like they weren't going to even be able to get into the bomb site. If they win that, probably they don't win the game because of it, but no. Instead of like 16-8, where we're at a much closer score. So there were a lot of rounds.
But that round itself tells that storyline. You were in a perfect situation. You had something like, what was it, like a 3-on-2 or
yeah.
a 4-on-2?
A 3-on-2 hold, yeah.
You had everything down, the bomb planted, and then in comes NBK and just cleans up, basically.
Yeah.
And then it's over at that point.
Yeah, that's maybe a good sort of a round to signal how a lot of that game actually went down.
No, that's the thing. But let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the map that's going to be coming up now. Because after having seen now what we can expect from these teams on cash, we saw a lot of it as well from 3D Max, at least in their match versus Dignitas last night on Dust 2. Do we think that this is going to work, this kind of style is going to work against what we've just seen from LDLC here?
I think it's going to be a different style coming out from 3D Max, just slightly. But I think they'll have more of a chance to use the defensive play on Dust 2 is a little bit easier and just have like a standard setup. But I don't know. I mean, LDLC are a really hard team, I think, to play against on Dust 2 because we saw some of the aim engagement going on at long range. And like Thorin was saying, when you have someone like NBK hitting shots like he was, I don't know. I hope they're going to play more standard to begin with. Try and see if that works, just for starters.
Do you think standard is what's necessary here, though, from 3D Max's perspective?
Yeah.
Because it seems like they...
I disagree, actually. I think you should go all out. Like, what you saw on that map there on cash was they tried to play standard, first of all. They tried to play normal spots. Just I actually think they were a bit nervous at first. They were trying to feel the game out. And then what happened was, when they were so far behind that they knew, like, this half's lost, they just went, right, well, there's nothing left to lose. Now we'll go really aggressive. And that's when they started getting results. Because what you saw then was the LDLC guys didn't have, like, super executes or something that were, like, unstoppable. And so if you could push up and pick a guy off early, it delayed them, and then they were thrown off a bit. And you could see LDLC's head wasn't entirely in the game. That key round where Kiyoshima got the boost up and he didn't kill a guy when he was having three shots on his head, that'll never happen again. So in this sort of a scenario, I think like the situation is right for a potential upset on the map, but obviously it doesn't matter if you put yourself in that situation. You have to be able to get the kills. And so if I'm the 3D Max guys, I need more from them if they're going to win a map.
What I worry about with aggression on Dust 2 as opposed to cash is that almost every team, if you just played 100 demos of any team playing on the terrorist side of Dust 2, they'll do the standard Dust 2 spread, right? Have a couple of people holding upper dark, a couple of people holding middle, and eventually they probably all end up in middle, and one guy holding long, on the terrorist side, that is. So what I'm worried about is if 3D Max try and throw in too much aggression, I can definitely see LDLC just deciding to wait for it. And on Dust 2, I'd say it's a lot easier for the terrorist side to wait, whereas on cash, like we saw at the B-bomb site, when they wait out to a toxic or playground or whatever you want to call it, there's a really good chance you're going to find when you go up as the CTs, when you go aggressive that side, that there's nobody there because the Ts are in middle toward A. Like that doesn't happen on a lot of maps, so you can actually walk out on out of a bomb site and find no terrorists. But on cash, you sometimes can. I think it's a little bit more difficult on Dust 2. So
Dust 2, yes. But what we saw from 3D Max yesterday and was some very great short play in particular. Not too love to peek short, and that was definitely something that Dignitas struggled with, and I'm curious to see if that's going to be another go-to strategy for them, rather than trying to just go for long control, pushing out from long, which is always a bit risky because of what you say, that 1-3-1 setup. If you can actually find a way to get onto short and put some aggression out there and put that in with the mid-aggression as well, we've seen that was work in the past for 3D Max. So I'm curious if LDLC, having watched that demo now, are they going to be prepared to be able to deal with the 3D Max sort of defense, which is a little bit still, it's aggressive, but it's a little bit random as well. Does it work or not?
Yeah.
Thing is, as well, Dust 2 is a map as well that really does play into good AWPing. And we saw some of the rounds they were picking up there was when they had the AWP Zata, or whatever he's called. He was hitting shots. He had his position pretty well. So if he can get some strong AWPing, especially mid-control, then potentially you have the chance to make this a competitive map. But on the numbers, you'd say that LDLC are a favorite to win this map. Like, the problems they had on that map won't necessarily carry over, I don't think.
So speaking of Dust 2 in general, they've recently extended the bomb planting zone so that it actually goes towards the short side. Which is something that I'm guessing, I mean, we've seen already a lot of teams trying to make adjustments for it, but I don't think we've anywhere near seen the sort of the complete difference that's going to make in the overall map. But I'm wondering if because that change is very recent, maybe 3D Max will have a bit of a chance to catch LDLC, you know,
well, we saw them
being
use
less
that
prepared.
Yesterday. We saw them use that yesterday, so that's the scary thing here, because we already saw them go for a strat that they used yesterday as well on cash. But I don't think LDLC picked up on it in the second round, where they really focused on A. I don't know if this was intentional or not, but 3D Max did go for that B stack yesterday on cash, and LDLC were definitely going towards A early on, so I don't know if that was a coincidence or if that's something that was taken into account, but there was a clever strategy used by 3D Max yesterday as well on Dust2, where they abused that short plant,
yeah.
The new short plant that you can do now that plants on the other side of the boxes from long, so you can completely ignore out long in A slope and just go ahead straight plant with a smoke, and we saw 3D Max go for that. Now, are LDLC going to be like, well, you know, we know you have this strategy up your sleeve.
Yeah, and the reason I bring it up is because you're right, we did see that, but interestingly, we also actually saw what the counter to it was from Titan, which is that if you save enough smokes that the people on short are never going to be able to come through and stop the defuse,
sure.
Because you have so many smokes or Molotovs. That's what I'm wondering. That's why I was, you know, questioning that is LDLC, have they picked up on that? Because if they haven't, there's a chance that 3D Max could get some sneaky rounds in there. Mm. So what do you think about that change with the bomb site? I mean, do you think that's something that's a very subtle change that has potentially big implications to the game?
I mean, I think the reason why the thought behind it is to try and give terrorists more rounds, to give them more room of where you plant. Like, you know, like if you're trapped in the site on that particular site, it's very hard to hold that one angle.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so in general, we've seen one of the trends in CSGO is it's a very CT-sided game. Even a map like Dust2, historically so terrorist-sided, we now see the top teams actually win the CT half sometimes. So
yeah.
I think this is a move to send it more towards that. And I'm not against that in general, actually, because I think it is actually better when you have a good mixture of CT-sided and T-sided. So if we got a map like Cash in the pool, for example, very CT-sided, then you want a terrorist-sided map, if possible, to balance it out.
Mm. And I can think of a few other maps where the bomb planting zone is really, it annoys me anyway. Mirage on the B bomb site is the most famous one, I think. I think in the old version of Mirage, you could plant a little bit further out, but in the current version, you are sort of trapped within that building that's over there, the pillars. And sometimes it makes for some very, you almost never see people planting on the, you only see people planting on like one corner where the firebox is on Mirage and the B bomb site. Mm. People almost never plant on the other side unless it's a very particular situation. So it sort of also says that, not that I'm a big fan of heat maps in general, but I think if there was a heat map of bomb planting positions, they'd be very heavily stacked towards one side in that bomb site. So
well,
I think
that one side in that bomb site is the one that you're talking about.
Yeah.
So you're covering that angle from kitchen and you're also protected from short. So
exactly.
Or you're planning for short, basically, if you have short control. The one thing here is that, you know, the bomb plant that we're talking about on Dust2 is essentially, you know, the short plant for Dust2 was also a bit of a long plant as well. So you always had to take that risk. You needed to have long control if you were going to plant for short, and then that was a bit awkward. So this just opens up the options to have a very clear long plant and a very clear cat plant.
And I mean,
it also takes away, actually, some of the overly passive play you could sometimes see from CT, where they would just put the AWPer in the pit there, and then they would just lock that area off, and they could wait for you.
Yeah.
Whereas now, if you take that risk, and you're the long guy, and you don't peek in when they're going into the site, you can get completely zoned out of the map because you'd have to go all the way behind, and that's very difficult when you have an AWP. So again, it plays out of the favor of CTs and into the terrorist's favor, I think.
Yeah.
And I mean, as a tool to change the game, it's a very sort of might, you can do it like really easily. Whereas if you try and change the game, you know, in favor of the terrorists by buffing their weapons, I mean, the repercussions are way bigger. So
yeah,
I feel like, you know, changing bomb plants is maybe a good way to go forward anyway.
It's an interesting option. I'm just curious to see I'm really just curious to see if there's going to be any kind of like homework done here that's really going to apply to this game, or if 3D Max are going to have another strat in mind that's going to potentially counter what LDLC would do to counter, right? You know, they're getting into those bluff.
If you ever watch like NHL or NBA, where they play a 7-game series and there's days between each game,
sure.
The thing they always stress when they're doing the analysis is like what the adjustment will be from what was done in the last game. And usually, the theory you usually follow is that the team who lost the first game has more potential to adjust something from the next one, because the other one thinks, well, what I did works anyway, so I'll stick with that. And usually it's the team who lost. Now, in this particular situation, I can actually transfer that to where LDLC could get a benefit, which is that LDLC saw the Finns play on Dust2 against Dignitas, and they saw them win on Dust2. So they can actually see what was done successful there. And if you're NBK, if you're Shox, you can sit down and go, okay, we already have quite a versatile set of things we can do, so let's just specify, specifically make sure that can't happen again. Because if you take that away, now we don't know, can 3D Max win in a different way, or will they win with a different style? Will players be able to change positions, for example? It's quite unlikely, actually. So if I'm LDLC, that's probably the approach I'd take.
Yeah, they're going to be looking to cut 3D Max's legs out from under them. That's definitely the game plan here. We saw a bit of it on Cash when they swapped over to their CT side. Aggressive pushes around the map, making sure that 3D Max don't have time to set up and accelerate. And I expect to see the same here from LDLC on 3D Max's, or when 3D Max on the T side. But going into this already, 3D Max, yeah, got the man advantage on this knife. So I'm not sure if it's going to really matter for LDLC which side they actually start on. I don't think it does really apply to them. They're going to be comfortable on which, on CT or T. 3D Max, I think, would like to get the T start, though.
So welcome to the second map, everybody. This is it, LDLC and 3D Max. There's a one map lead currently for the French LDLC. They did win it 16-8 on Cash. And well, it's going to be 3D Max's turn to pick a side, and they want to stay on the terrorist side. There is one detail here that is worth pointing out when it comes to Dust 2, and it's a guy named Smiths and that AWP of his. That's something we really can't underrate. It's been proven in the past to be a factor all on its own. And they even have Shoxi as well, and Shoxi has a very particular style on Dust 2 with the AWP as well, of playing the middle hyper-aggressively. So those are things, I don't think they're going to catch 3D Max off guard, but the thing is, even if you know what's happening, it's still pretty hard to stop.
It is. I mean, because, well, the thing is, do we actually see it work here? Because we've even seen other oppers pick up Smith's style of opping, which is the flash over mid-doors and Smith's crouch peaks, and manages to pick somebody off almost so consistently it gets ridiculous. We've actually seen other oppers start to adapt that style. So is Smith going to have that go-to here, and he's going to make it work versus Xart, who's going to be obviously the other man here for 3D Max, who's going to be a part of that battle, the other side of that battle? Shoxi going mid-aggressive is something that's going to be curious, that's going to be interesting to see. But we're already into the pistol round here. 3D Max, T-side start, and they're going full YOLO onto the B-site. No surprise here. It's unadulterated aggression, and they get right out onto the bomb site. Full control.
Great headshots from Natu. Two in a row, and LDLC are utterly out of position. Look at this. One guy rotating completely through spawn. The bomb is already down, and they do have a kit on MBK here. So he's going to be the key man. If he goes down in upper somewhere and they lose the kit behind, that's a big problem for LDLC having only one kit. So now Shoxi's moving close, already being shut down quite for low on health, and his third will pick up the one here. MBK has to stay alive. If he dies here, there's no chance to get defuse the bomb, so that's really critical, and he's going to be alone. All gone. Now two with a triple kill at the end, and 3D Max off to a great start.
3D Max picking it up right here. That's it. And now that was a fantastic hold. Just great aggression. That's kind of what we were expecting to see out of them. Just get in their face fast. Don't let LDLC set up and get comfortable. Put that experience right to use. It was just 3D Max, get in there fast, get the damage done, get that bomb plant. And when it came down to the hold, they landed the shots when they needed to. So already Reflex actually dropping fairly low here, and it's a bit of a battle at mid, but we do have a man sneaking into lower dark, and that's gonna be Shoxi.
Yeah, Kiyoshima actually will find a headshot on Xard. That's really, really annoying. Then right through the middle doors then. So that one scout already proving pretty effective. And the thing is, everybody else on LDLC actually do have armor and pistols. And because they've taken so much map control over Laura, and Kiyoshima is there on long, taking down this third, that's ridiculous. Now, all of a sudden, 3D Max find themselves in a very tough position.
And Shoxi is still here. They're still here. They're going to close in. It's going to be a sandwich. They're looking to pincer in LDLC right now. Are they going to be able to figure this out? Caron. And check this angle, it's just so close right now. This is very dangerous because they could potentially get the drop, the full surprise, and LDLC, they would tear them to shreds, but Caron spots them out in time, and they're not able to spring the trap. He's gonna get the double kill, and that's actually the defense gone from B. Caron could lead the charge here and take that control of that bomb site.
And you're exactly right. If they had taken longer, and if that had been a prolonged fight, probably Happy would have been the guy running in from short, and things would have been very different for 3D Max, but they're playing so patiently. This is actually just a very intelligent counter-strike coming out from the Finnish team here. Very hard. I mean, we've seen so many top teams. Oh, Kiyoshima. There's no accounting for that. That's now a triple kill with a scout.
Yeah, that's Kiyoshima for you. And he's going to be able to get onto this B site. The jump shot. There it is! He tags it! It's the Songair Scout! He's got it! He's already landed shots left and right, and he's gonna do damage with the P2K as well. He finally gets overwhelmed, but Happy's got the Galil, and they do it! LDLC come back in the second round and crush through 3D Max. Despite the patient play from 3D Max, LDLC manage it.
Oh, and there's probably a little bit of frustration there, because they actually played that very smartly. I was gonna say, in the top scene of Counter-Strike right now, so many top teams are very, very bad at playing these anti-eco rounds, and 3D Max are showing some really nice skills in slowing everything down and recomposing themselves and then picking up those frags to actually make it into a 3-on-3. Just couldn't really count on Kiyoshima being that good with the scout. Now Smith is going to take a kill in the middle and a second headshot to follow. It's a bit of a shooting gallery here, and he's going to get some help. LDLC are pushing up very aggressively over at that B-bomb site.
a dangerous position for Happy to find himself in there. That could have been a gun drop for 3D Max if he got caught, but six HP, still controlling his spray well, and he manages to get the job done. So no plant there, so that means 800 bucks not picked up for 3D Max, so we'll have to see what kind of a buy they have going into this. But they're going to want to apply the pressure again, and we're going to have to see exactly where they decide to take this right now on this T side. LDLC, however, they should be fully equipped going into this next round, so it should be perfectly fine for them.
No doubt about it.
All right, well, actually 3D Max double eco territory, so they're not going to be buying up. It's going to be just a situation where LDLC should be able to pick up more frags. A couple pistols picked up here for 3D Max, though, so LDLC, they have to be a little bit careful. Smith's getting into a bit of a tight spot, dropping down to half HP. He's taking the duel, and somehow it's going to be Zart getting caught in the end. The flank coming in from CT will do the job, and that's actually two very solid anti-eco runs coming in here for LDLC. That's not what 3D Max wants to let happen here, because LDLC, it's all about controlling the money, and if LDLC have enough money to be able to buy it for consecutive rounds, 3D Max's job is so much harder.
It definitely is, and especially because if LDLC have the money, there's no doubt we're going to see at least one AWP. Once they lose a round, LDLC will absolutely pick up one AWP, but question is if they're going to go for two or one on an auto sniper, and if they have the money for it, they just have so many options. And that in itself is a bit of an issue. So here we see the standard spread that we were talking about from the terrorist side, you know, ending up in the middle with a couple of people, then one guy holding upper, one guy holding long. This is what everyone does. Unless they're rushing or going for a really crazy strat, this is what you do on the terror side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're just looking for control. We're going to be seeing the flash in, and 3D Max are very good about that as well. They're always flashing for each other around corners. This is something that most teams have actually learned to fear about them, because if that flash is there, okay, maybe it's a little predictable. They could be right behind it, but 3D Max at the same time are so effective making it work. So it's a very difficult thing for LDLC to deal with when that does come through, and we'll have to see if 3D Max are going to be able to abuse that. But Zart goes for the flick shot, and he's not going to land it. LDLC managed to spot him out, but they don't spot the bomb, so we don't see any kind of rotation coming out here from LDLC. They're going to hold to their positions for now.
Thing is, if NBK hadn't got into the pit, I think he would have been in a very bad spot up by next to the pit. Now, smoke going to go up here, and this is an exceptional smoke timing for Happy. About 35 seconds and the smoke goes down, and he has a Molotov. This is going to be very hard for 3D Max to get through, but actually they're not going to wait for the smoke. They're just going to go right in, and Kiyoshima will pick up that first headshot. There's a lot of people here for LDLC. 3D Max have chosen the wrong bomb site, and Shoxi and Kiyoshima will land the kills. Happy goes down. They're actually fighting their way out of this. 15 seconds left. They need to get that bomb down, but the two remaining LDLC members are already here. Karan charging up. He wants to get that done. 7 seconds here. They got upon it quick. Shoxi's alone. One on two here, and he's got to go down. Great play. Reflex will pick it up. And 3D Max actually fighting themselves out of a position that they probably shouldn't have won to begin with.
Yeah, LDLC are going to be shaking their heads after that one. That's definitely a situation that they should have been able to control. Happy playing from Goose as well. Tries to flash himself out, but he got picked up out in the middle of nowhere as well. So that really allowed for the pressure to come onto that side from 3D Max. And
the Molotov never got put down like it should have been. It's a big difference. Reflex and Disturb charging out on long here and picking up the LDLC members. And this is the round where they've actually invested into that AWP from Smith's. It's just, right now, it's completely not in position.
No, exactly, but this is the kind of aggression we were looking to see here from 3D Max as well. Just get out fast, land the shots, run and gun style, and LDLC may not be able to expect that in time. Now we may see the adjustments coming out, seeing as 3D Max is starting to get a little bit of momentum and confidence on their side, so LDLC, they need to put a stop to this quick. But already, 3D Max, they're in a prime position to pick up a round here. A two-man lead and control of mid. They could be moving up towards A, even though the defense is going to be weak on the B side. Happy manages to find Disturb, though, with that AWP. And this is actually a double AWP play here for LDLC. If they start running up on Cat, Happy is here.
Shoxi lost his down on long, and it's really cool to see Happy picking it up. So there's some really heavy artillery. In fact, the B bomb site's completely open, and they have time to run right now. 3D Max, if they raid the right call, they could win this round so easily, but they're going to go where it's absolute hardest, and Happy will pick up another kill. He does miss that shot, and they're fighting their way through. Kiyoshima burns alive, and Reflex will pick up the last kill, and there it is. Even at the hardest bomb site possible, 3D Max are actually outgunning LDLC right now, which is
a real pleasure to see.
Didn't expect myself, hear myself saying that.
But that right there, Disturbed, getting that opening frag on Shoxi is huge. Getting rid of that AWP, the pressure is gone from that position, and then he's able to just follow up with the momentum. Now we see 3D Max, they're going to just go barreling onto this B site, no time wasted. They don't want to let LDLC recover, they just want to keep the pressure up as hard as they can. And Smith is going to get the drop on one with the CZ-75, he's still alive, but just barely gets taken out there by Zart. Man advantage now for 3D Max, and they've got the bomb, they've got the site. Everything should go their way here in this round. They should be able to actually close this out.
3-on-4. Yeah, the best LDLC could do at this point is look for some good exit kills, and that's also why they've wrapped around pretty much all, you know, all around the bomb site, just hoping that they can catch 3D Max coming out of the bomb site and stealing a couple of rifles away from them. This is going to be 4-on-3, and 3D Max are actually playing really well at the moment. LDLC going to have to come up with an answer for it, and I'm not really sure what it is.
MBK is making the ugliest skin in the game work, and he sets it up as well. Reflex gets caught by Shoxi, and now look at this, 2 AK saved by LDLC. This is a big win for them. As far as they're concerned, this is about as good as it gets. Sure, they lost the round, but that's all right. They're on the CT side of Dust too. If they can force 3D Max to spend money like this in the next round and save two guns to boot, LDLC are going to be very pleased with how this round went.
Without a doubt, that's a big victory for the French team. And being on the CT side, they need the money a little bit more than the terrorists do. They had the double up setup, and that didn't quite work out. So they have an AWP back on Smiths again, and I'm wondering, he's waiting, and they're excited on the other side, but they're at different angles, so no one's going to catch each other here. And Smiths looked like he was going to go aggressive, because that's something LDLC have actually only done when 3D Max have had pistols, more or less. Could be fun to see LDLC throwing in aggression when the rifles are in play.
Exactly. If they decide to push around. I mean, that's an element of CT Dust 2. There is that aggressive option there where you start pushing around the map, perhaps getting into lower dark, pushing. There's a very popular play now is actually pushing in from lower dark and pushing in through upper dark at the same time from the B site and just kind of sandwiching whoever you can find in there. But that really is effective when 3D Max don't go for mid control immediately. And 3D Max right now are being very thorough with their map control. They're not letting LDLC find any of those openings to really get out there and do kind of early damage that would slow down 3D Max.
Molotov and flash through the smoke there from Happy's teammate to try and see if he can net himself a kill. And again, look at how slow the Finns are being here. There's 40 seconds left, and they still are just in the starting positions, essentially, which is not necessarily a bad idea, but once they get going, they have to land a really quick opening kill. They can't have any prolonged fights when there's only 30 seconds left.
Exactly, and there we go, Corone with the entry. Hazard does manage to pick it up. He robs him of the frag, but it's going to be out through B, and hello, Shoxi's here. Smith has the AWP as well. He catches Hazard round in the corner. He's got to pick up the second frag. Natu is gone from upper dark, and it's down to the last man alive here. Reflex with the bomb, and he's not even going to get it. He stops just short of picking up that bomb. 10 seconds left. He was trying to make a getaway, and he gets caught off. LDLC managed to stabilize in a crucial round for them.
Yeah, and what was unfortunate is because they actually got the entry frag in the middle, that should have been a big opening, but they didn't smoke off CT spawn quick enough, and they didn't have a smoke going into it. So ultimately, they just got shut down from multiple angles. And now it's 4-4 right into the ninth round, and 3D Max are the ones echoing once again here. So LDLC hold on to a lot of rifles, including that really expensive AWP.
Yeah, that crucial rifle there, 4750 is the cost of that gun compared to around 3K for the rest of them. So it's definitely a big investment. Happy up here close in CT, however, could be in a bit of a dangerous position. They're close by with the P250s. He's definitely within lethal range, but he's going to go for the mad spray, just holding down Mouse 1. And NBK splitting everything up, and he's going to go hunting for more here. Happy looks for the man on cat, not going to get it. Spots out Caroni, he's looking for the shot. He's going to go for the knife. Are you kidding me? Happy, you cannot live through this.
One.
Wow.
points for style there from Happy at the very least. Yeah, he wanted to slice and dice, but doesn't work out that way, and luckily he had a single bullet left. So I think it's the LDLC manager in the background having a little bit of a laugh there.
I mean, at that position, it is worthy going for the knife, because that's $1,500 you get for that kill. So I mean, if you're both out of bullets and you can get that knife, go for it. But that was definitely a bit of a risk there. And there it is, Smith. This is the thing, Smith's going for his tried and true. That's his style of opping at mid, and Zart, he just gets the timing down perfectly. Shoxi, however, has pushed up the top cat, and he's picked off Caron.
Yeah, Smith had already tried it once before where it failed, so the repeat got him killed, in fact. Zart ready for it, reflex. He's going to be taking down MBK, and now, again, 3D Max not really doing much here, but they are putting one guy down in pit. I'm sad that there's not the guy with the AWP, though. I think it's Reflex who's down there currently. If they had an AWP down here, it would be a lot better, but Happy does have one on the other end of the scale, and he's going to be dropping Reflex.
Instant.
Still going to be an A push here.
Wait, they're going to have the smoke. Shoxi can't throw that smoke now. It's going to be Kyoshima pushing from upper dark. He's going to actually draw a man out. This is going to be interesting here. 3D Max stand their ground, and Zart lands the shot on Happy first. Shoxi's going to be over here to lend a hand, but he gets smoked off in this nade. Oh, he gets out in the nick of time. Pop flash to do it, and he manages to trade frags, but 3D Max stabilize and hold on to that round. But that was a there was some acrobatics there from LDLC. That was way too close.
It looked like that grenade was going to be enough, and then it looked scary because of the flashbang follow-up. So who knows what happened in all that flash madness. Going into the next round, though, I hope that 3D Max saved that up. I think they did, yeah. Someone picked it up. Double up setup again for LDLC, Shoxi and the Kiyoshima. So not Smith. Interesting change of pace here for the French team. That is actually pretty significant, I guess. I mean, Smith did miss the last battle in the middle. Maybe that's enough to make them think, all right, we'll let someone else do it.
Yeah, trying to change it up, right? There's options here, and it's not as if he's in a bad position to use it either. On B site, holding up a dark like that, that op can be deadly. But 3D Max, instead of going towards B, where Kiyoshima is lurking, they're going to go ahead and take over A, managing to take out MBK over at long. That's not going to help things. Smith does manage to find a shot at range on Zart, so...
That was all the way down suicide.
Yeah, that's a crazy shot to land with a rifle.
From mid to almost T-spawn with a rifle. So I guess that was just better than an ult for him. All right, okay. Then. Now Smith is getting some interesting information. He's going to be flashed in, and actually Shoxi spots one, and he misses the shot down here. Looks like they're going to try and go up long, and there's a guy hiding by the car. They got to check that quick, and Happy will get the one. He can't see a thing, though. The pistol's out. It's not going to be enough here. Shoxi missing a lot of shots with the AWP, and Molotov to follow. Now he's going to have to move his position a little bit further. He's still burning. Got to move Shoxi. He's got a one health, and he's finally going to be crisped. Now it's a 2-on-2. Natu and Reflex here. They've got 30 seconds. The bomb is going to be actually thrown over there, so nobody has to make the cross. And look at LDLC. They have no grenades, whereas... at least Reflex has a 1 HE here. Gonna peek up. Well, now to going for the battle, and he's gonna come out short.
Reflex is gonna get caught as well. Kiyoshima finds the headshot through, and that's gonna be LDLC with ample time to get the defuse, getting control of that site and managing the retake there. Not too sure about that positioning there from 3D Max at the end. I mean, they wanted to really just put up a strong fight, cutting off CT. But at the same time, planning for long like that, you can't just get all the way back in that position and then just stop the defuse from coming in that way, playing ultra passive. Just 3D Max deciding to go for a bit more of the aggression there, and this time around it worked out just fine for LDLC.
Yeah, and I think they didn't know how close the LDLC members were by the time they were putting down the bomb, so they probably just went for the first part possible, basically, instead of really having like a laid out plan. I think that happened so fast for them. LDLC over on long are going to be trading 2-for-1, and it is an eco round coming out here from the terrorist side, and great shots coming in right now from 3D Max. They're doing significant damage. Smith could get caught here as well. He's very low on health. They're charging in. And the C-set is going to keep him alive a little while longer.
And Happy is just like, oh, peekaboo. I'm here too.
Those guns are just much less effective when they don't have any bullets in them. Can't really do much.
Send it back. The warranty.
No, there are bayonets in the game, but they're not on the rifles. I guess if they were, you could stab someone with them. That would be effective.
Or Pasha, he doesn't even need a bayonet, he'll just stab you with the gun. There you go, flash from Smith, and that's how it's supposed to work. Zart gets picked up at mid, and this is why Smith is feared as an offer on Dust 2. He's got these clever strats, and he just always seems to make them work.
Yeah. Ooh, Smith's very aggressive in the middle here. This is kind of what we were looking for from Shoxi, but Smith is capable of it. And actually, it's a trend that's sort of branched out to a lot of different AWPers now who try and do it, so it's not just sort of restricted to Shoxi or anyone else like that. It is still fun to see it. Natu and Reflex, though, not having that much fun at the moment, being, a couple of people down already, and LDLC really putting a lot of pressure on from all angles at this point.
Oh, good nade damage going out there. Natsu's under critical pressure. He's down to 2 HP, and he's boxed in as well. NBK is already waiting on Cat to catch him as soon as he rounds the corner here in the lower dark. Reflex is here to get his back, however, and he's going to catch Smith off guard, but Smith with that CZ up close doesn't manage to get the kill on Natu, who survives, but just barely. And LDLC will pick up another round here on the CT side of Dust 2. They really do look like they're in fine shape here. They get rattled a little bit at the beginning, but once the pace starts to slow down, 3D Max just can't seem to crack LDLC's composure.
Oh, they've had multiple opportunities. I'm a little bit sad we haven't seen that A push from them that we were talking about with planting, you know, in the pre-show when we were talking about the plant on the new side there. Mm-hmm. Hasn't really happened too much in 3D Max. Again, with the pistol, they seem to be doing good work here. Shoxi will pick off one, really close with the AWP, and he's getting some backup as well. So this is going to crumble here for 3D Max. They get the two kills in, which is still actually pretty respectable, but the five rounds they have on, they're not enough here.
No, they're not. This is definitely not ideal, but then again, at the same time, Dust 2, strong defense. We saw very strong defense from 3D Max yesterday in their match, so we can't really count anybody out until we see 16 on the board, or we're going into overtime here. So 15th round of this half. 3D Max eco'd for this so that they would have the money. And Zart, he's waiting on the left side. Smith's repositioning himself. He's not going to land the shot. Instead, I think he just tagged Shoxi.
Oh. So actually get the kill on him. So Shoxi with the aggressive movement. This time it backfires. MBK almost catching one, but he's being shot in the back, and this Sturg will pick up that one kill there. Now Happy is up on shore, but this defense is, well, it's almost non-existent for LDLC.
Yeah, this is where it starts to evaporate. And 3D Max, again, just slowing the pace. They want to gather up at this point, but you kind of do want to see them just drive it home, get the job done, get this half over, and swap over to the CT side. But they're playing this so very carefully. Great shot there by Zart, leading the way with that AWP on Cat. That's going to pick up Happy, and there's the final kill. Disturbed will secure it. Six rounds now for 3D Max here at the end of the first half, and they're definitely going to have to be talking over exactly how they want to approach this CT side now that it's going to be on their turn to weather the storm here. LDLC, that's one thing that we didn't really get to take a look at, really, is, you know, how are LDLC going to approach their T side? Are they going to be the ultra aggression, or are they going to try and slow things down and really stick to that 1-3-1?
Well, that's a good question. It's coming down to this round, basically, for 3D Max. If they could win it and make it all the way back to 9-9, there's still a chance, because then they'll have the weaponry to go for that tight defense that you were talking about. But if they lose it, I think LDLC are going to finish this game a little bit quicker, maybe, than 3D Max were expecting.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt about it. I mean, this is where it starts to get a little bit scary here. LDLC just getting control of long as well. There's still Corone holding it, cars across, so... No, that was actually a D-coordinate. He's up on site.
Our monitor is not that clear, so it's a little difficult to tell.
The zero and the decoy. All right, but it's going to be Reflex on Cat. And he does manage to get one fully blind. Not going to pick up the second, but still, the damage is done. Corona live on the site, manages to stop the flank coming in from long, and it's all down to Cat now for LDLC, and they're getting caught out.
Yeah, firing squad going on here from the Finnish side, and, well, MBK's alone, 1-on-3, and he's going to fall as well. So tight defense from 3D Max. They had a really good position. And I like the fact that they had such a big presence on short to begin with, because you can be pretty mobile from that. You can easily jump down into middle. You can pretty easily defend long as well, mm-hmm. especially with the USPS. So they had a lot going for them, I think, 3D Match with that kind of setup. So, well, keeps going. Kiyoshima has the scout.
Yeah, waiting.
And why not? And MBK has one too.
Waiting to see it. MBK, we've seen him use that before. You know, that was on cash that they were going with that play there. But Kiyoshima, after the first half on this one with the scout, that's, we're going to be looking for more of the same. Double nade is going to go ahead and ring Happy's bells, and that's not going to be too pleasant for him, but it's still information gained for him. And LDLC, in the meantime, they look like, because they know that there were two guys at least over at long, they are going to go for pressure fairly quickly here at mid. They could take advantage of this. Reflex is alive in CT, but he's burning bullets, and it's going to be the crossfire setup here on 3D Max.
Oh, and now it's broken as Disturb goes down, which leaves just one guy inside the B-bomb site. And actually, 3D Max aren't making that much of an adjustment. They're putting a couple of people more down in the middle, which right now would look like an A split. And if they just get the kill on long, I think they have this round.
Yeah, this is going to be so tough to hold. Corona's going to be able to get into this pit, however, or he's going to get caught out in the open, and that's not going to help things. Smith instantly overwhelms him with the help of Shoxi. And now Xard is going to be the last man alive, but he's getting wrapped around on. Happy's already out on this site, putting shots in, and Happy playing this safe, not showing himself. He can't let him get away, and he will not.
That's it. The long guy falls, and the rest is just easy pickings. So Reflex is coming up from behind. It's a 1-on-4, and he's going to get shot down instantly from Smith. So there it goes. That's, I mean, 3D Max, they lost the second round as well. In the first half, they won pistols both times, but they've lost both the follow-up rounds. And that's something that really comes back to haunt you.
Oh, yeah. Now, these are supposed to be rounds that they can count on picking up, right, to go ahead and bolster their score.
Look at it this way. 3D Max probably would have had the round lead if it wasn't for that right now. It's only 10-7. It's very likely it could have been 10-7 the other way if 3D Max hadn't been losing those rounds. But again, the Finnish team is actually not that far behind, but LDLC, I mean, there's a reason why we consider them the favorites going into this, and maybe even, you know, a contender to take the whole tournament here.
Certainly. Certainly. Whoever faces them are going to have to be on their toes. There's no doubt about that. We're seeing why. I mean, they do manage to keep their composure in these sorts of situations, and they're making the right calls consistently here as to where they want to take this on the T side. They get information, and then instantly, I mean, they have three great minds on this team right now. I mean, Smith, Shoxi, Happy, these guys have a lot to do with it. NBK as well, although he's not calling anymore for the team, that didn't last too long. He said that he couldn't get his thoughts across properly to the team, you know, in the heat of fire. But so it's been passed over to Shoxi to call in game, but NBK is still having a large part. I mean, there's so much experience on this team. It's very difficult for 3D Max to deal with here. And 3D Max looks like it's going to be another round of eco for them.
Yeah, well, here comes pretty quick rush into the bomb site and facing just pistols with an MP7. Shoxy is adding a little bit to his bank. It's not all bad. And Smith's in the middle also having a bit of a prolonged fight. Still, he can go onto the scout, and there's no reason why he wouldn't. It's working. It's a flawless round for LDLC to make it a 5-round difference here. Mm. Now it's down. I mean, I would love to see an open and auto sniper right now in 3D Max. I'd like to see them go all in on the defense here because they got to do it now.
Well, they're running out of rounds to do it in, right? We're getting into the late game of the half here, and, well, LDLC only need 2 rounds. Say they take this round, 3D Max have to eco the next, and then they're going to be fighting basically from a position where LDLC are going to be on 14 rounds. They need 1 round to secure overtime or better. It's just way too difficult, and already LDLC picking up both entry kills. 3D Max really trying to get aggressive here, and Zarda's going to find a frag, but then Shoxi comes right back into it, and it's all over the place. LDLC, they look like they want to get out into mid, but instead they're making the right call at this point. They're going to play the numbers game and slow it down.
And that's the really big danger with having CT side aggression on Dust 2 is there's a heavy chance you're going to run into that kind of terrorist presence in the middle. And when you do, it's not just going to be coming from the middle, it's coming from lower dark too, unless you have just very lucky timing. So they definitely got crunched a little bit then. It's not done yet, it's still a 2-on-3, but they are at the wrong bomb side right now with the defense. And all right, that's a nice toss.
Yeah, that's very smooth. Smith picks off Sart before he can rotate in as well. And now he's just the remaining member here. Happy's going to find him, and this is going to be a great situation now for LDLC, poised to take this second map and put themselves into the grand finals of their first LAN here as this new lineup. This is an excellent performance from them. 3D Max, they're not out of it, but it's still very much a difficult situation for them. They need to come back into it with pistols here. And those CZs picked up for 3D Max. Don't they know what's going on with the game right now? They just got P250s, Anders. Clearly, we found the weakness here.
Maybe that is it. I mean, it does cost 500 now. I think the money change, actually, I thought it would have almost no impact at all, but it does. You do see less of them now. It's only really sort of select players that do bring them up every once in a while. So, yeah, especially now with 3D Max are so close to losing the game. They're going to need everything in the upcoming round. It's a flawless round from LDLC. Really not a lot to talk about. LDLC just taking care of business.
Pretty much. 3D Max just trying to push around with the P250. LDLC also being a little bit aggressive. And in the end, the rifles prevail. A perfect anti-eco coming out there for LDLC. And that's going to allow them to build a little bit of bank here as well. So if 3D Max can pick up this round, LDLC are going to have good money going into the next one. But this is the crucial position now. Xart using Smith's own play against him. But he's not going to find anybody lurking. So has to change it up for the cat play. And he could actually pick somebody up here at top mid if LDLC aren't careful.
They're going to have two people up on short, two people down middle. This means nobody's holding long, but I don't really care. I think this is still a pretty good idea. But now that they're going forward, are they going to catch them on time? That's the big question here. They do a lot of damage early on, and they're going to fall back. The grenade follow-up is going to take down Shox. But then Smith with the return kill, and now Karon is actually the only one holding A. If he dies here, everything falls apart.
Yeah, it gets really scary really fast. That smoke, though, it was just a half second late to keep his mate alive, but Smith catches start rotating in through mid as well. And LDLC have set up shop here at mid on Cat. They don't need the budge. They've split the team in half. 3D Max, though, gets the perfect timing for a flank. But MBK will shut it down, and it's all down to Natu now. 1v2, lands the first, gets the second, low on bullets. He's got the USP, but he's not going to live. Happy chases him down on B slope, and 3D Max.
It's a brave attempt from Natu there at the end. Looked like, I mean, yeah, again, a few more bullets. Maybe you would have had that.
That was it. M4A4.
So just to reiterate, there are a couple of other ways they could have been holding over on short, especially with the AWP. If they want to, one of the really popular positions amongst some AWPers anyway is holding that ledge and then taking a quick peek if somebody drops by and then falling back into CT spawn if you miss it. But yeah, right now 3D Max are being really aggressive down the middle again, and this time they do catch off one and then a second one there from Disturbed. Very nicely done. Kiyoshima does get a return frag, but he's going to go down right afterwards. So well done from 3D Max, and now it's going to be NBK and Smith left.
Oh yeah, and Smith's trying to take a shot down at range. 1v4, he's got the bomb, at least he's got that going for him, but still, map is all 3D Max's at this point. Wherever he goes, he's going to be running into him, and 3D Max are playing this very smart as well. They're going to just play the clock, make Smith's come to them. And Smith, he doesn't really have too many options but to run in and try and just land a sick off shot. That's what it's going to come down to here, some miracle shots coming out from Smith's.
Yeah, I mean, winning this round, 3D Max still need to win 7 in a row because LDLC are at match and map point here. They just need one more round. It'd be one hell of a comeback from 3D Max if they can make this work.
I believe, man. Last night versus Dignitas. 3D Max, they're capable. Nice nade there. That's going to ring Smith. At this point, Smith, I mean, he's making a lot of noise, and 3D Max are hearing this, which is why we can see them closing in, and now he's been boxed in as well. So he needs to find the shots if he can, but he's not getting any luck with that. 20 seconds left. Flash there as well. He knows somebody's up on cap behind him, and now the smoke to go down as if taunting him. They're just toying with him at this point, 3D Max. If they could keep Smith alive past the clock, that would be funny, but they're going to get caught in the end.
They did still act kind of scared, like they were really worried he was gonna go insane just then, but they had it under control, no
doubt.
That
guy's on the other team.
Yeah, you're right. Maniac.
Kenny is what I'm thinking. I mean, it's still possible. I mean, Smith has his moments. He's more of the hold angles and just as soon as you go by, I'm going to shoot you in the face sort of offer, though. He's not nearly as explosive as, say, Kenny or Guardian.
15-8 right now. This is the second map right here, the second half two. The Frenchman moving kind of aggressively up short. This is a change up for them because they've been just holding mid for a long time, and that flashbang almost takes care of Ixad. He's going to be careful here. A few more bullets and he's gone, and he's going to have to play defensively, but the problem is, who's going to take over holding the A bomb site right now? Nobody is, so they got three people down on long, and they're going to lose control of A, and because of this new position, and we finally do see it here, LDLC don't have to care at all about what happens on long. They can just hold it here. The one thing that's working is that they do have a smoke and a Molotov on 3D Max. So if they want to retake it and force them out of short, maybe that can work. But this is really hard. This is really tough.
This is incredibly difficult. And look at MBK's positioning as well. He's going to be able to pick them up as they try and go up CT slope. That smoke is actually helping disturb somewhat. He's landing shots, but MBK is there going to pick him off. It's going to be Karol now, who's getting two kills or just the one, but still manages to clear up the site. It's a 1v2. He goes for the smoke, and he's going to be holding on it. And LDLC, are they in position to stop it? They're going to miss! 3D Max!
Wonderful. The knife comes through, but it's too late. Great smoke, and that's what we were talking about. Having those grenades at the end to defuse like that, it makes such a big difference. And that's a very impressive retake from 3D Max. That was a 1 in 1,000, I think.
That's everything going right. Look at this. LDLC, this plant completely worked against them in the end. And you almost wonder, was he swinging his knife? Because we weren't seeing what MBK was doing there, but was he swinging his knife trying to get lucky with it?
I think he was trying to knife. It's almost a get right on train moment, right?
Yeah, right.
Grenade down low is going to take care of Disturbed, unfortunately. So it's still a 3-on-3 here. 3D Max, they need more. They need a lot more. 6 rounds in a row is what they're looking for. And LDLC were able to buy this round, maybe helped by that bomb plant. So it isn't quite over yet. The one thing that last round that... Oh, wait a minute. Karon instantly realizes someone might be lower, actually. That's, again, some nice game sense.
Yeah, the
but
timing.
LDLC weren't really focusing on holding short. So that also meant that plant, they didn't get the full effect of it, essentially.
They weren't really trying to stop it, you're right. They were kind of like wishy-washy, moving in, NBK having to come up from slope, right, ZT slope, and that's, I mean, it's a bit awkward. He still managed to pick up two kills there, NBK, but the rest of the team kind of couldn't quite handle the push that was coming in, and Sard is going to find Kirishima trying to push through. At mid, this is going to be now Smith leading the way, looking to land that shot with the AWP. Not going to find it. He gets baited out and misses the flick.
Yeah, smoke goes up. That means there's only one guy holding the B bomb site right now, but they have the man advantage. And I mean, right now, Natsu should know exactly what's coming for him here. He's just waiting, wants one guy to peek first. Happy looks the wrong way. Natsu now being spotted out. He still picks up the one kill, turns around. He's right on top of him. And one more click, and there it is. Natsu with a double kill. Fantastic round from him. Very important. LDLC not able to find him in that corner quick enough.
Incredible as well, once they figured it out where he was, but Smith's not able to get the job done there. And that's just going to be it. Not too good control there, but exactly, like, Smith's. That was very odd. Okay.
And, okay, they can actually still buy. I'm wondering if we bring up the scoreboard real quick here. So now, yeah, LDLC are starting to run low. They have a pretty big bank on MBK considering the situation. But if 3D Max starts to force eco rounds on LDLC, the game does change a little bit for the Finnish team.
Yeah, this is where it starts to get pretty scary, and there's Karon managing to pick up Shoxi already. Good push, and this is the thing. 3D Max love to play aggressively on short, just get up there and poke and peek, and this time around it does work for them. They come out of it ahead and do massive damage to two of the members on LDLC as well. MBK and Smith drop dangerously low here. So this is where LDLC starts to get a little bit worried, I think. 3D Max, there's closing in, and if LDLC don't get a plant this round, it's going to be very touch and go for them in the next.
A great flash in. Karon somehow hasn't picked up the kill, but look at how low MBK and Smith are. And Reflex is there to help him out. Again, they have a good setup here. And now The Molotov just burning more time off the clock as well. Three on five here is what we're looking at. Happy with a really good long-range headshot there. But I still think 3D Max have a better position right now.
They do. And this is going to be Caron stepping in. Oh, NBK can't quite manage that second kill. And now it is that 1v3 situation. Happy has to run up. He doesn't have the bomb. It's dropped up on Cat. And that's going to be a bit of a problem for him. 27 seconds left in this round. And 3D Max are willing to let him run up there and get it because they know they've got the huge man advantage and they've got the flank coming in from Natu as well at long. So 3D Max picking up another round and no plant for LDLC. Anders, they're not getting that bonus $800.
No, they're not. Now they really should go for an eco, even if they lost a couple of rounds in a row. And even if NBK can drop for a guy, I still think it makes more sense for the Frenchman to switch it up a little bit here. And that they will do it. NBK pieing AK armor is not so bad. That just means he sort of equalizes with the rest of his team in an economic sense. So that's all right. 27th round is coming up here. And it's still going to be really tough for a 3D match. They've done a great job already. And if nothing else, they've definitely shown a lot today. Again, today they've shown a lot, but still a long road ahead.
Double nade. Oh, just barely dodges it. All right, scary bit of moment there for LDLC. They had an opportunity to start off strong, but it's going to pass them by the wayside, and now LDLC are trying to gather up. It seems like maybe looking like a B-split push here. I mean, the bomb is making its way into upper dark right now. Happy trying to get information if anybody's holding that angle on B-slope, and it's going to be Zart through the wall picks up Smith. That's a nice wall bang there with that AWP. As soon as this smoke clears up, though, they have a smoke as well as a flash. Shoxi could be setting up for the play here for his mates.
Natu in a really good position here. Probably going to be almost in a free kill as they come in first. And then the question is, well, backup is close by already. So yeah, 3D Max is still in a great position here. There's the first kill. And actually, MBK with a really good return. But the Molotov here is going to keep them from running through. And Disturb just taking full advantage. So 15 to 12 is what we're looking at here. Happy in this 1-on-4 with 25 seconds left.